To base be the glory.
Yo. Hey. Yo. Mary Kay Ashley. What's going on, chat? We back. Got the sauce on me. Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust. Oh, fuck. Hey. What going on with y'all?
Don't need no introduction, I'm a fool.
Oh.
School girl, but I didn't make it out of school.
Oh.
Mama told me how to raise a fool.
Oh.
I didn't listen. I was optimistic. And now I'm in the studio. See no competition.
Hey. Yo, yo.
Let
me clear my glasses. I can't see.
Woo!
Dang. Oh. I'm about to take off my dogs later. I forgot. What we about to do? We about to fuck it up. Hey. Hey, West Side niggas always. I like my hat. You can't even tell. Oh, not the devil. Fuck it up, don't fuck it up. Fuck it up.
That's what I'm here for. I got shots still out here. I'm a four-way. This movie don't need extras. I'm two-way. Chessboard, you would think I'm all-way. And you know, I'll keep a two with a
bug. West Side, nigga, know we bug. Does that lie? You know we bug.
Yeah. Okay. Wow. Okay. Clap it the fuck up, man. What the fuck is going on with y'all, boy? You know what I'm saying? Oh, and another beautiful motherfucking Sunday. Beautiful motherfucking Sunday. Another beautiful day, as always. With your boy. With the kid, you know what I'm saying? With the kid, with your boy. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, we back. We back. You know what I'm saying? Yeah.
This is a certified hood classic.
Yeah, we know that. We know that. We know that, man.
Whew. Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Hey, me too. We in that thing. We in that thing. Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy. Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
All right. what the fuck was getting into today? All right, now my glasses are blinding me. I don't know how glasses can do that, but they are. What we getting into today? Just some YouTube shit, as always. We might hop on the game, we might not, as always. But if I don't get on the game, then I'll probably end up playing it tomorrow. But anyways, how was everyone's day? Hope everyone's day was motherfucking fantastic. Fantastic. Mine was chill, you know what I'm saying? I had an off day today. I woke up not that goddamn long ago. I wanted to stream and make breakfast with y'all. Should I do that next time? Like, next time I'm off, should I, like, make breakfast with y'all or something? Because that's what I did this, well, not this morning. By this morning, I mean, like, an hour ago. But I should do that. I just don't know. Well, I guess I can take my, cause I'm using a laptop, so I'm pretty sure I can just take my laptop downstairs. But it's just the mic situation, cause this wire ain't that long, so I need some wireless headphones or something. But if I can find out how to, I think I'll just buy some wireless headphones and I'll do that. Cause once I can do wireless headphones, I think I'll be straight. Why do I need headphones again? Why do I even need headphones? I don't even need headphones. I'll probably end up playing music anyways. I'm gonna do it. I don't know when. Probably next week or some shit. Next Sunday or something. Either way, hope everyone's day is going fantastic. Hope you had a fantastic day. What the fuck y'all had going on today? Y'all go to church? No? Y'all recovering? It's recovery day for people that went out on Saturday and Friday and Saturday? Or is this a chill day? Or did you have to work today? What y'all, you know what I'm saying? What y'all getting into? Yeah. I slept in, ate some breakfast, cleaned up my little area, my space, you know what I'm saying? Showered and shit. I didn't really do much. I ain't go cap. I don't need to do shit today. You know what comes out though? What comes out today? A show comes out today. I just don't know what show. I'm trying to think of it. Fuck. What fucking show comes out today? Fuck. There's a show that comes out today. On HBO, I forget the name of it. The Last of Us. Holy fuck. The Last of Us comes out today. So that's gonna be fire. I ain't gonna lie. The Last of Us comes out on HB motherfucking O, nigga. That shit gonna be crazy. Should we watch the trailer for it again? I'll watch the trailer for it again. I don't mind it. But yeah, we got that. What else are we getting into? Oh shit, what the fuck? Hold on. I'm trying to look for it now. Last of Us trailer. Cause I honestly forgot about it. So we got The Last of Us. So what are we getting into? We got YouTube. We got a button video. What we got? Let me look. We got, what the fuck is this? We got Danny Brown, Schoolboy Q. We got JJ in the fight. We got, we got some things we can get into. Nothing too crazy. Nothing too crazy. But yeah, man. Some trailers, some vlogs, some music videos, a little bit of everything. Some news. Some shit I seen on the news. Yeah. So at the start of this, let's just say, you know what I'm saying? I hope you're doing okay mentally, physically, emotionally, spiritually. Hope your mom, your dad, your sister, your brother, your cousins, your uncles, your nieces, your nephews, everyone you love, everyone you care about, I hope that they're doing okay. And I hope you're doing okay. Matter of fact, more than okay. Fuck that. It's 2023. It's a new goddamn year. We should be doing more than okay. We should be at our fucking best at all times. Knock on bullshit, I have not worked out at all this year. I have a morning routine. I wake up, I pray, stretch, and I do like my little push-ups, and I do what's this shit called when you work on your abs, when you like on the ground, plank. And I plank for like a minute, and then I plank for like another minute, then I do like another like 50 push-ups. So I do like 100 push-ups and like plank for like a minute or 2 minutes, like every morning. But that don't really do shit. That just keeps me like, I don't know. But I haven't like actually like worked out. So that's something I actually want to do. Cause once I get my shit together, I'm gonna be on this bitch shirtless. I mean, I can be. I'm not like crazy. You know what I'm saying? I am out of shape. I feel like if you can't walk up a long flight of stairs without breathing heavy, you're out of shape. So, yeah. And as I was cleaning my room this morning, nigga. I can't even see myself. Oh, nigga, look what I found. Look at this old ass iPhone. I don't even know what iPhone this is. This shit cracked as fuck though. Look at this. Look how small this bitch is. Hello? 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 You know what I'm saying? Like what kind of I forgot what kind of charger this was. I don't even know how to turn this bitch on. I forgot how to turn this bitch on. It's probably not. Because this shit's from 10 years ago. Hell no, this shit ain't gonna turn on. Oh wait, it was this button. I forgot how to turn this bitch on. I legit don't know how to turn it on. I'm pretty sure it's like the top button and the home button, right? It's not gonna turn on. This shit dead as fuck. But that one... And not gonna lie, this one's an older, this one's a newer one compared to this one. I think this is the 4 and this might be like the 3? Does this bitch turn on? I doubt it. This bitch don't turn on either. I wonder if I can charge it. Hold on. Does it take the same charger? No. Oh, it do. It's charging. Holy fuck. Okay, we're gonna let that bitch charge. We're gonna see what the fuck is in that. I don't even know what's in that phone. And then, before I even had an iPhone, nigga, I had a goddamn prepaid LG Virgin Mobile fucking bullshit sidekick. That's what your boy was talking to the house when I used to have house. When I was talking to the house. Yeah, what's up? Well, I wish I had a sidekick. I couldn't afford that bitch though. I ain't gonna cap. This bitch still kind of player though. Like I still rock with this. I ain't gonna front. I still rock with this bitch. On like some, you know what I'm saying? Like on some, you know what I'm saying? How you turn this bitch on? How the fuck you turn these phones on? Is that it? I feel like this just needs like a USB cord. I know I got one. Got one right here. Hold on, let me see this bitch. No, this bitch look too big. Pause. I gonna fit. It do fit. Say less. I'm about to charge this bitch up right now. What is in this phone? I don't even know how long I've had this. They got a piece of gum on this. Like, what is this? I got a piece of gum stuck on this bitch. Hello. Yo, this is crazy. I don't know why I kept all these charging. Oh, fuck. It's charging. But we're gonna come back to it. I don't have a charger for this. This might be a 3. When you used to have those fat ass fucking thick ass fucking chargers and shit. I might order one on Amazon. Should I order one on Amazon? I think I want to. Hold on. I might order one on Amazon. I ain't gonna go. Let me see if I can find one. iPhone 3 charger. I think it's a 3, right? I mean, it's not gonna tell me, though. Oh, yeah, it is. That fat ass charger. $6? Shit. Shit. $6 is crazy. Yeah, that's it, though. Hold on, let me turn my brightness down. Alright, now y'all really can't see. Fuck. See that fat ass charger? Hold on, green light? Yeah. Alright, so I'm gonna buy that bitch. It should be here on Tuesday. It says free delivery Tuesday, because the boy got Amazon Prime. So this shit gonna be here Tuesday. By now. Proceed. Oh, fuck. 752. All right, whatever. All right, shit gonna be here Tuesday. Say less. All right. And these motherfuckers are still charging. That hoe's charging. And I got the iPhone 4 charging, so we're gonna come back to that. All right, let's get into our reactions for the day. Fuck it up. Where's my phone? My actual phone. I need a new fucking case, bro. Look how chipped my fucking case is. It's fucking gross. Hold on. What the fuck was I about to do? I was about to do something and I forgot. What the fuck was I about to do? Oh. Sauce on me, nigga. Sauce on me. Yeah. Okay. Alright, just checking. What should our first reaction be? Let's check and see what the fuck we got going on. Fuck it up. West Side niggas always fuck it up. I wanna watch this Danny Brown and Schoolboy Q video.
There is no peace.
Nope, there certainly is not, ma'am. Always get hit with the Addies. Oh, well. Was today a good week for y'all, chat? Today was an okay week. I'm just glad I got work over with. And I had today to, like, it was the first time sleeping in all week. I didn't even really sleep in like that, because I told y'all I'll wake up mad fucking early. I didn't even get to sleep in like that. But, because usually I wake up, I gotta be at work at like 6:30, sometimes 7:30. So I end up waking up at like 5-ish, 5:30, 5:45 type shit. And today I woke up at like, what time I wake up? I woke up at like 8 because I had to pee. And I was kind of just on my phone till like 10 and I went back to sleep and then I woke back up at like 12. No bullshit. And then I played Call of Duty Mobile on my phone, obviously. And checked my emails, texted a few people, and got up, clean, showered, ate. Now I'm here. Yeah. Okay. Let me get OBS out the way. Wait, hold on. Let me change Got one. Let me get OBS out the fucking way. Hold on, how's that look? Cause you know how I always lag, is because I was using Windows something, and now I'm using Display Capture. What the? I can't see myself. Okay, I see it. Hold on, I'm about to move my camera a little bit though. I don't like how that's looking. About right there. About right there. All right. Hold on. I'm looking at it on my phone. You're it? Talk to me. Nope. Still look uneven. Why that shit so uneven though? Bro, bring up fucking Streamlabs, pussy. The fuck? But right there. Just wanna cover that little, you know what I'm saying? Nope. It's like a little, like a tiny, I'm sorry, I'm OCD when it comes to that shit, bro. Like, I don't want no, like, you know what I'm saying? Yo, what the fuck? All right, that's good enough. All right, how I look? Am I too much in the way? Nah, I should be all right. I should be all right. How I sound? Nah, I should be all right. I sound sexy. I ain't gonna care. Yeah, what sounds sexy? Wait. Bro, what's up, bro? Fuck yeah. West side nigga. All right, let's get into it. Danny Brown, the schoolboy's cute, schoolboy cute, high school advice. Now I'm a grown ass man.
Oh, hey.
Hey.
Welcome to Danny's house. I'm Danny, and this is my house.
I can tell. Type man, shit.
I was just thinking about high school. It was delicious.
Some of the delicious. Pink. Fuck.
As you all may know, I'm
sorry. I fucked up. Nah, I'm not. Should I show y'all what I looked like in high school? I got my yearbook. Oh, actually, no. I was never in the yearbook. No. I actually never took pictures for high school. That's a fire video. It's a fire motherfucking Vizio. I fuck with it. Mr. Danny Brown. Yeah, it was fire. Bro, I'm cold as shit. Hold on. I'm cold as a motherfucker.
Damn, this fuck. It's almost 3 already.
Yurt. Nigga, I'm cold, bruh. The fuck else we got in this bitch? I think we got a button, the button, right? Yeah. Yeah, let's get into this button video. Check what this. Well, before, let's. Where's my phone at? How do you turn this bitch on? Right here?
battery off. It's still charging. How long does shit take to charge? I don't know. All right, let's watch the button video. Damn, this shit was a week ago. Fuck.
Markets are down. Buy the dip.
Buy the dip. How about buy my dick? Excuse me. And why did I see Charlie, talking shit about Velma? This nigga done made two videos on how she, bro, why I look like that? It look dark in here, but it don't at the same time. Does that look a little better? That looks a little better. Should lower it a little bit. Not right there, that's fine. I feel like I don't look yellow. Yellow. What was I saying? Oh. I said, I don't know why this nigga Charlie was talking shit about them. He made two videos talking shit. Like, damn, nigga. Because they black? No, I'm sure that's not the reason. But still, like, damn. All right, the button.
It's Joe Rogan.
You really like him?
Joe Rogan is your crush. First of all, if a bitch say Joe Rogan is her celebrity crush, leave that bitch right now. Especially if you black. Leave.
Yeah, I don't know why. Like, I think it's the testosterone.
The testosterone.
I mean, I guess. He's a liar.
There we go. Welcome. Get her ass up out of here. Joe Rogan. Not to say he's a bad looking dude, but that's a weird. I've never heard anyone say Joe. Not to say, you know what I'm saying? Cause he is in, obviously he's in shape. He can fuck people up and shit. But like, that's a weird answer. I don't trust a bitch. I watch Joe Rogan regularly, literally. I went to sleep listening to his podcast last night. But if a bitch tell me she listened to Joe Rogan, I don't know if I trust her. I'm gonna be honest. I don't know. I don't know if I trust him.
And swap out their date for a new person.
Get out of here.
If two people can last on a date for 10 minutes, they win an all expenses paid second date.
Damn. Bitch, you're going out the country.
I'm Rhea.
Okay, she a little thick, Donnie. You know what I'm saying?
Fun fact about Donnie.
Fat ass nose.
Marvel nerd. Are you into Marvel?
You know what? No. Like, my brother watches them.
Why is this nigga sweating so much? Why he kind of creeping me out. I'm sure he's a good dude, but the Hawaiian shirt, he's sweating. He looks like somebody's father. Girl, press that goddamn button. He breathing. He got two.
But I just can't get into anime. Like.
Oh, girl, how? I was on the girl side. No cat. The girl's kind of, you know what I'm saying? She's throwing a little thigh and all that, you know what I'm saying? This heavy breathing nigga. All right.
Like, you can't not like Marvel. It's amazing. There's so many different things, and it's not anime. It's just like a bunch of superheroes who try to save everybody.
Yeah. I'll give it a chance. Okay. Maybe. It's nice to meet you.
Your person has to like Marvel films, right?
The comics, the movies, it's just I have a dog named Marvel, so it's kind of a...
What? Oh, this nigga's a loser. I'm not... Even if I love Marvel or DC, I'm not naming my fucking dog Marvel. Is that a good dog name? Marvel. It feels cringy to me. Maybe it's just him.
You rejected me because I didn't like Marvel.
What? Hi. I'm Donnie.
I'm Mia.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. So, tell me about you. What do you do?
Grew up in California. Moved here 6 years ago.
I have a fun fact.
Nigga, she was about to press... What? She was about to press the fuck out that button. Look at this.
Grew up in California. Moved here 6 years ago.
I have a fun...
Bro, she was ready, too. She couldn't wait. Oh, you can't... Oh, I'm in the way. Fuck. See, I don't know where to put myself, bro. But she was pre about to, you know what I'm saying? She was pre about to hit that bitch.
Fact about Mia. Oh, God. She was a competitive figure skater for 10 years.
What?
Yeah. I live near a rink that still produces Olympians every year.
That's crazy.
Yeah. I gave up about halfway through, though, because I was like, I don't want to do it. And I kind of just switched to like Disney on Ice type of shows.
Okay.
Donnie is a big Marvel nerd. Are you into Marvel?
I made the effort to sit down and do all the Marvel movies, and I think I stopped after like the second one in order just because it felt like too much of a task.
Oh, here we go.
Favorite Marvel movie character, anything like that?
Spider-Man.
You're absolutely lovely.
No.
Oh, no. Was it Spider-Man?
I just didn't get the initial spark. That was really it.
That's fair.
Such a pleasure to meet you.
Nice to meet you, too.
Yeah. Cool.
It's a little sweaty ass. I don't like this, like, showing what the fuck is going on. But, like, I don't care. It's giving too much. It's giving too much for me, if I'm being honest. Like, I don't care. Just bring the niggas. Like, I'm seeing what y'all sitting at a lunch table. Y'all got snacks and waters and shit. Y'all eating Cheez-Its and shit. Like, I don't need to know that. I don't give a fuck. Apparently she didn't like Marvel movies. She didn't like Marvel. So I tried to press the button. She pressed it before me. Oh, Lord. No.
Oh, the men are very excited that I rejected him, apparently.
I'm Don.
I'm Mia. Nice to meet you. Yeah.
Nice to meet you. So, what do you like to do for fun?
Well, I love going out and, like, exploring, trying to find out.
You know, but hold on. Before you know why I don't like it? It's because it makes it feel like people are just trying to press the button to press the button. Just because, oh, this bitch pressed a button on my nigga, I'ma press a button on you. It shouldn't even be like that. Like, it's like, I don't like that. I feel like they should keep everyone separate or something. I don't know. I just don't like, it's like, oh, I'm pressed a button because she pressed a button on two other dudes, so I'ma press the button on her. Because now the game is about pressing a button versus what the game is for. Speed dating, finding love. Now it's this thing about, like, you know what I'm saying, boys and girls. Like, it just feels weird. I don't like it. But whatever.
Places and things like that, but like 90% of the time I'm at home knitting with my dog.
I love dogs. I have a dog myself.
Oh, what type of dog do you have?
He's like a mini golden doodle, so he's like, yeah, very fluffy, like looks exactly like a teddy bear.
Doodles are so cute. Yeah. I love doodles.
She's gonna
I'm sorry.
It's all right.
You're just not my type. Like, I think you're beautiful, but
what's your type?
Probably like Asian girls.
Totally.
Yeah.
Oh, why do you have a racial preference?
Why do you have a racial preference? Oh, Lord. This is getting crazy.
I think there's just, like, that cultural disconnect that's kind of hard to get over.
Totally valid. Lovely.
So she's going to go in the back and be like, he only likes Asian girls. And then watch her only be one Asian girl. And she's like, nah, I'm good. Tough luck,
yeah,
buddy.
Yeah. No, you're great.
Sam,
Don. Nice.
Definitely not Asian.
I like the outfit.
Asian appropriation.
I do cosplay often. It's like I've been doing it for 10 years.
Is cosplay a little bit of a sex thing?
It's not something, a sex thing for me. I've just never done it in cosplay before, but it is a very popular thing.
Yeah.
Because people are like, I want to fuck my favorite character.
Yeah, I think it's just like, you know, like role playing, like living out kind of like a little fantasy type thing.
Exactly. Why did you press the button?
I'm just not that attracted to you. I'm sorry.
Sure, thank you.
Oh my God, her feelings were hurt. Her feelings were hurt. You could tell her feelings were hurt. Oh, Lord. This is brutal. I mean, it's not brutal, but it's just like, why did you press it? Huh? Why'd she fucking press the button on me, huh? Why'd she fucking do it? It's like, I'm just not attracted to you. I'm just not my type. Okay, thanks.
Hi, what's your name?
I'm Christy, how about you?
Christy, I'm...
The only Asian bitch in the entire... not Asian bitch, I'm sorry. Asian woman. Probably in the whole show. And he's like, oh, I fuck with her. But she gonna press the button. Watch. I know what's going on here. He ain't fooling me. First of all, look how skinny this bitch... I mean, woman is.
Sports, mm-hmm. Basketball, volleyball, tennis.
So she's all right. Not my type. I haven't seen a girl. It's my type.
I'll play anything.
Sorry. No
worries. Yeah, why'd you press it?
I feel like we have like good like friend vibes, but I'm not like necessarily like attracted in like that way. I'm sorry.
No, I respect that.
Yeah, okay. Nice to meet you though. Yeah, nice.
I look like brother and sister.
I'm not a big
Is that racist
fan, though, so when he was like listing all of that, I was like, I'm sorry, I'm not there.
I go.
I pressed it twice.
You know what's the funny thing? That I think people think they have to like the same things in order to be with each other. Which is not true. I mean, I feel like you only need a couple things to relate to. You know what I'm saying? Like, if y'all don't like to say music, well, actually, I feel like music kind of runs deep because I don't think I've ever been with a woman and she doesn't like the same, at least around the same vibe of music that I like. You know what I'm saying? So I don't know. I feel like music's different because music hits deeper. Movies, I don't know. I feel like it depends. I feel like you can not like the same shit. Like, if this person likes Japanese food, and this person likes Italian food, and this person hates Italian food, that person loves... You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I don't know.
You knocked out too, huh?
Yeah, knocked out too.
Uh-huh.
So,
why is it a...
Yeah,
well, because they talk, you know?
Yeah, yeah, they're screaming out really.
Of course, because women talk, dude.
Yeah. Why is it about pressing the button? This is not what the show is about. It's supposed to be, you're supposed to be finding love. Obviously, it's not gonna happen. But like, I don't like that this show is becoming about pressing the button on somebody. I'm sorry, have mercy, I'm about to bust. I don't like how it's about pressing a button on somebody. Like, I don't like that.
How have you been feeling?
Kind of nervous. Like, I don't know if you can tell, but my lip is quivering because I can't, like, contain. I can't contain my nervousness. Nice to meet you. I'm Christy.
I'm Alfred.
So what do you like to do for fun?
I like to hike, longboard, anything outdoors. Mm. I like to surf. I'm from California, so.
What about you?
I think he beat you to it.
That was weird.
I'm sorry. Okay, I just didn't feel the spark.
No, that's okay.
I'm sorry.
Yeah, it's okay.
It's nothing about a spark, nigga. That was weird as fuck. What the fuck y'all got going on? Why the fuck would she? Why the fuck did she just sit there and not say shit? She's weird.
It's cringy.
Cringy as fuck.
I'm Alfred. Nice to meet you.
A little fupa.
Celebrity crush is Joe Rogan.
Yeah, get this bitch out of here.
Yeah, I don't know why. Like, I think it's the testosterone.
Like, I mean, I guess. He's a liar.
Yeah.
I feel so bad. Oh my.
I know.
You're just not my I'm so sorry.
Yeah, get that little fupa up out of here, shawty.
Alfred, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Alfred.
What's your little fat nose at? Let me stop. No, I'm just being me.
I don't know what it like.
Yo!
Not a kid. I want like 4 eventually.
That's kind of a lot.
What about you?
I got a fat nose, but that nose is crazy.
I don't want kids, no.
At all? Yeah, you're done, shawty. Get up out of here.
Like, not at all?
No.
Why he say it like that? Like, not at all? Like, not one, not like half, not like adopted.
That's kind of a lot.
What about you?
I don't want kids, no.
Like, not at all?
No.
Bam.
Fuck out of here. You're gone. Fuck up.
I'm so sorry. How do you not want kids?
It's a lot of work.
What's your dating age range?
Oh, well, I'm 36.
36.
I would say like...
Oh, he pressing that button.
Yeah.
28.
40. What's yours? Am I an old lady?
Yes.
I'm an old lady.
I'm sorry.
He said yes.
I feel like a really bad person.
I feel like
looking for in a partner.
Okay.
I'm looking for someone who can talk to me.
Okay.
Be real.
Yeah.
You know, someone right. who likes adventure, not just stay in, even though I do like staying in sometimes.
She like she burns incense.
I'm sorry. You're just not my type. I'm sorry.
What is your type?
I don't know.
You don't date outside of Latinas?
That seemed cringy.
My brother. We going me and Dr. Umar Johnson gonna have to have a word with you. Nah, I was playing. I think my type is Latinas too. I ain't gonna cap. But I mean, I've dated black girls, white girls, Hispanics, Asians, Indians, European, Russian, Armenian. I've dated a lot of different girls, but for some reason, Latin women, Hispanic women seem to kind of be on the same page as me, if I'm being honest. Either that or black women. So if it's not a Latina, then it's probably a black woman for sure. I'm not hating them for it. You know what I'm saying? Everybody got their goddamn preference type shit. You know what I'm saying? This is like, you know what I'm saying? That's just a weird question. It's like, why? It's like asking somebody why they like the color blue. It's just like, because it's my shit. Blue's my shit. I love the color blue. That don't mean I hate every other color. It's just blue's my shit. You know what I'm saying?
That is not what I meant. Shit. They're gonna think I'm an asshole.
Prom. She got buttoned by the same guy? Get him the fuck out of it. See, this is exactly what I mean. I hate this. He just didn't show your type. And now it's like, oh, get him out of here because he pressed a button on three girls. So now, fuck him. He's probably a good guy. But now you're pressing the button for the wrong reasons. Get him up out of here? Why? He just didn't see someone he was attracted to. Now, she look good. I ain't go cap. Shawty on the left. She got the body yaddy yaddy. So, I don't know. And that might be his type. And she might fuck around and press the button on this nigga. He like, bitch, nigga, you my type. These niggas could have fallen in love, had kids, got married, and all that. But no. Because press the button on his ass. Fucking do it, girl. Press the button on his ass, girl. He did it to three of us. Do it.
How are you?
Hi, I'm good. How are you, Laura?
Alfred. See?
Hi, nice to meet you.
Alfred has rejected a lot of women.
I have heard.
Let's get right to the point. What's your type, Alfred?
I'm looking for someone who knows who they want in life, someone who's confident, independent.
Okay.
But you also said something else.
Yo, the button need to get off his dick. The button on his dick.
Okay.
What about you?
I like a man who has his shit together.
She's pressing that button. She's pressing that button. That's so rude.
I'm Latina. Hi, I'm Laura.
See what I'm talking about, bro? See what I'm talking about? He wasn't gonna press the button. But she pressed the button specifically because they say, oh, do it, girl. Press the button. He did it to three of us. You better press that button.
Sorry,
I'm sorry, I'm out of breath. I was just playing ping pong.
Oh, nice.
How's your experience?
Press the button on this bitch.
I mean, this is my first time doing this, but the girls...
Oh, that's a good question. How was that? How was walking into a sorority of women, all juiced up on whatever, you know?
Juiced up is crazy.
Back there is testosterone. I'm not sure what is the...
I guess
the
estrogen would be it.
Right, right.
I mean, honestly, the girls are amazing.
And how did you establish yourself in the hierarchy? I'm just kidding. But kind of not. Like, that's just, like, inherently human dynamic.
I mean, I don't know. I'm a friendly person, and I'm really honest.
You seem
honest.
Like this.
Yeah, same for you. You seem just, like, super down to earth.
Laura has a serious shopping addiction.
Oh, get up out of here.
To kind of clean that up, I'm a wardrobe stylist. So I'm always on the lookout for shopping and for things.
Okay,
and
so it sounds productive.
Jesse.
What?
Is addicted to nicotine patches.
Well, so people don't know, nicotine is a nootropic. So a nootropic is something that helps your brain be good.
Nootropic?
But yeah. I think it's dangerous to be in a sober state for too long, for me.
Interesting. Yeah. What do you do for work?
Run a company.
Oh, so you have a lot more freedom where you can.
Oh, right, yeah.
Do you find each other attractive?
I do find you attractive.
I find you attractive, too.
Okay, okay.
Do you want to go on a second date?
They are.
I mean, I would like to go on a second date.
I would.
All right, I'm going to light up one more time.
Okay.
If you don't press me, right. You will win the money.
I ain't mad at it. They look good together.
So awkward.
sorry. I had the second guess.
You said you go on a second.
I certainly would. Yeah, I think I would. I think you're great. But
you just rejected her.
Yeah, I went with my gut. Yeah.
Okay.
It's a heuristic I have. So it has to be a very strong, overwhelming yes, otherwise I catch myself and then I'll default to no.
I can feel that.
I'm an insane person.
I think that was the right choice that he made, to be honest.
All right.
Oh, yeah. That was awkward as guys, fuck.
I don't know. Game time. Body. Functions. I feel so bad.
This thing is a robot.
But that's the nature of the beast.
Oh, my God. This thing is an AI. This thing is the button. That nigga is the button. If there ever was a button as a person, nigga, that's the button, nigga. That's the male version of a button. But, yo, nigga, who the fuck told y'all to go on a goddamn commercial? An ad. Ain't nobody asked you to do that, my boy. That was kind of crazy. I ain't gonna lie. He said, he wasn't an NPC because he was spitting, but like he was definitely he was on something. He said, I don't like to be sober for too long. Neither do I, my brother. Neither do I. That feels weird. The button, see, this is why the button's weird, bro. I don't know if I trust the button anymore. You know what I'm saying? I haven't reacted to the button in a really long time. And that's probably why. Because it's not about finding love anymore. It's about pressing the button on people so you're not... I'm sorry. Being humiliated? So people aren't making fun of you. Fuck. That shit crazy. Why does it do that? Bam. Bam. Up. About right. Chill. See, now I gotta check. Why does it move, though? I don't like that it moves like that. Oh, that's fine. It's fine. Oh, Kai Cenat shops designer sneakers and clothes for his 21st birthday, featuring Phantom and Clarence NYC. Let's get into it.
They believe in us. Pat Moon did.
Yes, sir.
Hey, hey, hey. Now that I got it, I'm shopping. I ain't no product. I ain't out it. You wouldn't know nothing about it, yo.
What's good, YouTube? It's your boy, Pat. We're waiting on a special guest. His name is Kai Sinet. Just got an award for the Stream of the Year. He has shopped with us before, but it's his first time visiting the vault. So we're very excited. It's his birthday week. He's going to Miami.
Damn, look at all them shoes, bro. I wish I had a closet that looked like that, bro.
Stay tuned, and he'll be here soon.
I'm jealous of celebrities when their whole closet, they have a whole closet for just shoes. That shit crazy.
Yeah. Welcome to the mysterious
pest. Yes, sir. We in the motherfucking spot right now, man. We got all the drip and shit. He said he gonna he
drippy.
Said he
got the drip,
so I'm gonna see if he got the drip for real. This shit whack. I'm gonna let y'all know, alright?
We got something for you though.
Okay. Let me see. Talk to me. Let me see. Hey. Okay.
Okay. They got the.
Cake is fire.
Birthday tomorrow.
Just for you.
Cake is fire.
Appreciate happy that, birthday. Bro. What the fuck?
Love the cake. Where's the shoes?
That's fire, bro. What
are we going to do?
It tastes really good.
Lives. Oh, I'm going to Miami.
You going to Miami?
Yeah. Miami. You know how I feel about Miami.
Got some people on the way.
All right.
You know how I feel about Miami.
How we got? Appreciate that, my boy. All right, what we got?
Yeah,
you can he got that shit. No, I got Clarence and shit.
I see some chrome heart in the back.
What is that?
Let me see. Oh, okay. You got some Supreme. Bro, let me see some shit.
Okay, so look, I'm going to Miami. Yes, you know, a little hot weather, a little bit. You feel what I'm saying? So, like, what shorts you got? You feel me? Shorts, tees.
Size small.
I like this right here.
I need hoodies, jackets.
You know, this is a little bit Miami.
I'm going to Miami with him.
Yeah, he's coming with me.
Yeah.
We got all the shorts over there. We're going to start with all the shirts over here as well. Okay. So, wherever you want to start first.
Some hats.
Shirts, you go around the inside.
I don't see no pants. It's all right. They got in here. What they got? Let me see. Come on, bro. Y'all over here, bro. Okay. Sex? Ooh! Okay, yeah, I fuck with that. I like that. It could be a little better, but I like the set. Oh, yeah, I fuck with it. That's heavy. You can't tell me that's not heavy. Sex records? That's heavy. I wish it was, like, more in, like, a... let me bring up my OBS just real quick. Yeah, fuck is you talking about? 6,000, nigga? Nigga, get the fuck out of here. Goddamn, 6,000. We not doing that, my boy. We not doing no 6,000, bro. Fuck. I got bills. You talking about some 6,000, man. What? Hell no. Take that shit back, nigga. I ain't gonna lie, nigga. I'll buy an old army jacket, nigga, and I'll draw sex on it myself, nigga. Fuck. Put a little patch on the, you know what I'm saying? No. 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 That shit's hard, though, but like... It's not 6 grand hard, I ain't gonna lie. Nigga, 6 grand, you can buy a car, nigga. Like, I'm not, no. Do not pay 6 grand for no jacket, nigga. I'm telling you, don't do it. Shout out to Phantom, Flay, shout out to Chris, Yurt.
This is crazy right here,
okay? Yeah, you got a pouch on the side for 6 grand. Does it come with a bitch that sucks my dick every Monday? Because if it don't, you can take it back.
But you know, it's two tones.
Oh no, that's hard. I think the shirt looks better.
But these niggas is rich though, so this is a whole. Oh, okay, damn, that's kind of fire. Hang on, that's fire. That is kind of fire though. That is kind of summery, Miami e. You know what I'm saying? Throwing a tank under that bitch.
Yeah,
I'm not an impulse buyer. You just I'm like,
hell no.
Probably throwing some ones. Not some ones, some Air Forces.
Like, Dominique, you be buying fits and wear that shit one time. Nigga, I need to wear my shit 100 times throughout the year.
100, nigga.
You just won a Stream of the Year, man. Congratulations, bro.
The yellow bucket hat, fire.
Of course, bro.
What was your, like, come up? Like, how did you, like, go from where you was at to
now? Just came into an interview.
I was in the start of New York. going crazy. And then after, I'm in a group called AMP.
Yeah.
And we all moved out here together. That's fandom right there. AMP.
You're.
And then, like, we got four other people.
Mm-hmm. Well, hold on, they gave me some.
I bet. I mean, just almost.
He said, hold on.
We all moved to Atlanta together.
Mm-hmm. Oh, really? Yeah. Gotta love fam.
We all from the same place. We all from the
Bronx. So you guys know each other for a while.
Yeah. Everybody from here from the Bronx. Yeah. But we all know each other for a little bit. And then after, started going crazy. And I started streaming and going crazy.
Yeah.
That shit's crazy.
Yeah,
no,
that shit is.
You need another member?
Hey.
We'll let you know. We'll let you know.
Type shit.
Have you seen it?
How the fuck he got Air Force Ones?
See? Tell him. Air Force to go with that bitch.
Yeah, Drake made fuck on us. So this shit flow. 500, I'll go with the original AF1. Like,
I was just about to say, those are the same price tag as the regular ones?
It costs a little more.
A little more. Just a
little more. These are Drake.
Older certified lover boys. I rock with those.
I said, were they the same price?
And you can, like.
That shit really white. That shit really white. Yeah. Fucking up so fast, though.
Yeah. I'm fucking up so fast. Like, you can put this in the shoelaces.
It's hard wearing like, white shit,
whatever.
Bro.
Yeah, like, whatever you want.
That is hard.
Yeah.
I just get the original shit.
But isn't Drake your guy?
No, Drake is my guy, man. But
he said, but isn't Drake, but Drake your guy?
So the thing with Air Forces, bro, I run through them shit too fast.
Right.
Like, I wear them, they get dirty, on to the next.
Getting what he had me. You're about to meet him, right?
Yeah, we gotta give away. We gotta give away and shit. So.
Alright, so I want you to take this and then.
Oh, you gonna give it to me?
Yeah.
Oh, shit!
Fire.
So that you can wear it.
Oh, yeah.
On the day.
Oh, yeah. You know what? Yeah. Actually, whenever the time is.
Yeah.
I'm gonna go wear these right here. Whenever you make that call, I'm gonna make these right here. I appreciate you, my boy.
That's fire.
he got me a whole birthday cake at.
He put it in the back.
He got me a whole birthday cake off the walk-in. That's crazy. Oh my god, y'all got that shit. Y'all got some vertebrae in here too.
Okay.
Y'all got that shit in here.
Okay.
In here.
I'm a sweatpant kind of nigga.
Yeah. You a set type of nigga. You like matching. This nigga always got all the sweatsuits. You got any of these yet?
I like being comfy.
You got any of these guys?
Nah, Jesus, but I crazy. Know this nigga. Jesus.
He need the blessing.
He said he need the blessing.
Shout out to Murder Bray though, man. You should fire.
Look at these. Yes. Those gallery shirts, huh?
Gallery?
Gallery shorts.
Yeah, I'm gonna bring some gallery shirts.
I got the small ones.
I ain't gonna lie, this might be the go-to, bro.
We've been telling us to pull up.
I pulled up twice.
And then, what's it called? When I pulled up twice, it was just strictly your sneakers and then you only have shit. Unless he was tucking this shit away. I told Pat, I said, yo, Pat, you don't be showing me no love, bro. He said, bro, all right, bro, I'm gonna take care of you, bro. So we gonna see what the final price is.
I'm on my nap bucket hat calling your name, bro. I ain't gonna capture you.
Let me see it. So I'm gonna have so much. That's like, yeah, that's gonna be Prada.
What jeans you wearing?
It's some gallery jeans. That's OD.
I see what you're saying.
I don't know. Go. I go every brand, man.
Like, the jeans only count, like,
yeah.
You know, it's a brand, but, like, the jeans.
It's really the.
Yeah,
really
it's
really
the
would
top.
Would you do this LV?
That was stupid with
you. Fuck, nigga, I would be in the years with a fucking sheep.
Yeah. Not in Miami. Yeah, that's kind of crazy. I ain't gonna cut.
Why am I about to solve a crime, nigga?
You say you got mad shit on your mind. Yeah, you thinking about some shit.
It do it like in the winter though, in the city.
Oh, yeah, if you bundled up.
Selling some kind of drug,
bro.
Sour. Those are the LV Air Forces right there.
You know that's going for some shit.
Like eight right here.
Eight?
Yeah, eight. Eight?
Sheesh.
That's not bad. I done did that. Yeah, that's not bad. Yeah, all right. Yeah, that's not bad. $8,000 for some shoes. That ain't bad. You know what I'm saying? Give me that. I take it.
10 plus right here. I don't even know what.
Nigga.
Yeah, I would just.
I ain't never spent over $200 on shoes in my life. Nigga, I'm telling you, on my life, nigga. I got. Trust me. If I show you my closet, I have so many pairs of shoes. Never in my life have I ever spent more than $200 on a pair of shoes. And $200, and the only thing that was close to $200 was a pair of Tims. Because it was like one fucking 98 or some shit. Or some Doc Martens or something. I'm telling you, on my life, I've never spent more than $200 on any piece of clothing. Actually, one jacket. I spent on a peacoat from Zara, and I think I spent $201. That is the absolute most amount of money I've ever spent on any piece of clothing, accessory ever in my entire life. Ever. And I still got that motherfucker. Ain't no way I'm going that bitch. I had that motherfucker since nigga, let me see, 2019. Still, that bitch right there too. Nigga, I can literally pick it up right now. Nigga, fuck.
Wait, hold on.
These are your size.
You got green
and a half?
They all nine.
So. We have an 8.5. These are eight. The greens are kind of fire. They would just be clean with a white tee. Some light blues and some nice blue jeans and some regular Air Forces. I ain't gonna bullshit you.
I think it's that though.
Yo, bro, don't do that.
I mean, if it's not,
you,
he can bring it back.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Just
come to the case. If
you're on some Miami shit. That's a fire gift. Yeah. You really got him what he wanted, like what he picked out.
That's crazy.
Dude, I ain't gonna spoil this shit. Fuck it. Yeah, facts. I don't wanna make you cop that shit. But it's Buckhead, not me, bro. You think Buckhead is?
Yes,
it is,
bro. Look good. Nah.
It's gonna look 1,000 times better with my dress out.
Yeah, once you get off.
But like. But this is daytime, right? This could be nighttime too, but.
That's some daytime.
That's definitely nighttime. Yeah, definitely
nighttime. Nah. I'm not feeling it. It's alright though.
It's a little season.
Straight like that. Nigga, get some motion and start copping bucket hats. The fuck?
That's your fourth time picking up.
Those haven't came out yet.
Short niggas up again, bro.
Little
niggas got everything, bro.
I'm telling you.
This is crazy, like.
It's a large suit.
Word. That is tough. You can go black tee.
Sure. This is alright. It's too plain, though.
You go to white tee.
It's just too plain. Like, I hate designer shit to where it's like, nigga, I could, nigga. I feel like you can buy that shit at Target. It just don't got the symbol on it. Like, I don't like shit like that. I want, you know what I'm saying? If I'm spending thousands of dollars on some clothes, which I'm not going to. But I'm saying, if I were, it gotta look different for some shit that I could just buy from anywhere else. Like, I'm not, you know what I'm saying? Like, your company logo is not enough for me to spend $3,000 on this shit. I'm telling you. I don't care if it's a Louis Vuitton hoodie. If it just say LV on the hoodie, nigga, no. I'm just gonna buy a plain ass hoodie off Amazon that costs $15 instead of spending $1,500 on just LV. Like, fuck that. For what?
Fuck that.
That's
crazy.
I'd rather pocket that money. Spend that shit on something else.
Oh, let me try that too.
Turn around.
Nah, nah, nah.
Should be too plain for me, bro. Some of these designer clothes be way too plain for me, bro. That shit gotta be crazy.
What size?
Medium. This go, right?
Yeah, for sure.
Definitely. Same color. See, I like that hoodie. That hoodie's clean. Clean.
These two are in the large, though.
I fuck with it. Because it stands out.
If the black is
stressed,
but you might.
It stands out. I like it.
No, the hat is for sure. I just don't think if I do hat, I don't
want
to
go.
You
don't
want to go alone?
Yo, with the hat, bro, you can't wear the hat, the shirt, the jeans. That's too much, bro.
So go black tee. Like a good black tee, though. Like,
yeah, you gotta, you know what I'm saying?
This is your fit? I don't know yet. Bro, I'm literally looking at everything, bro.
That chrome suit is so hard.
Yeah,
you're not getting it.
That chrome suit.
You getting shorts?
Bro, my mother, that shit is so beastly.
You getting the shorts?
Yeah, I'm getting the shorts. Wait, try it on. Let me see. Stop doing that, bro. You have to get it, bro.
Look at this.
I know.
Bro, y'all not finna talk me into getting some plain ass hoodie, bro. Get the fuck out of my face with that. I'm not getting that. That shit probably costs 10 racks or some shit. Nigga, fuck that. That's a plain gray hoodie. I've never even worn a gray hoodie in my entire life.
Bro, this is hard.
Look how plain that shit look. That shit look plain. Blech. I throw up on that shit. What the fuck are you talking about? Get that shit out of my face. It's Cromer. No. Shorts, I guess. I'm not into that, bro. Get that shit out of my face.
You don't see yourself wearing it?
I kind of like that color because it's kind of like it's summery. It's a summery vibe, spring vibe, like a orange. Reminds me like an orange icicle. You know what I'm saying? Those shoes, but you gotta have a crazy like shirt to match that bitch. A crazy shirt to match that motherfucker too. I ain't gonna lie.
I probably wear these a little more.
Yeah, because you're not wearing those orange ones every. You know what I'm saying? On the regular. I do like those. But you're not wearing those on the regular. You're not wearing those on the regular. That's what I'm saying.
Well, I have my. It was better for like family, like raising my family and shit. Yeah. New York is not so good for that. It's like, you know, like with the school and everything. Like, it's just, you know, like,
they like it out here better. Like, I know it's like a lot slower,
but certain things, I do feel like it's a little boring out here. Though.
Yeah, it's slower, but our nightlife is like that's really it. Like,
yeah, but all you guys do is club, though.
Yeah, so
that's I'm not a clubber. Like, I'm not.
Yeah.
What are you doing in New York, though?
You can be outside. Yeah, you can just be outside. Like, New York is
too far outside.
Yeah, like.
Bro, I want to move, bro, but I don't know what city to move to, bro. I haven't been to enough places, bro. I've never been to New York. I haven't been to a lot of different places. I want to find a vibe that's good to where I feel like I can, you know what I'm saying? Because I don't really like clubbing either. Clubbing is not really my shit. It's cool every once in a while, but, like, I don't, strip clubs is, like, whatever. Like, I need a place where I can smoke weed comfortably. Go out and have a good time when I want to have a good time. A place that has good food, but also I need to live in a place to where it's suburban and quiet, but not quiet enough to where it ain't no bullshit going around me, but where I can like blast music, not like crazy to where I'm, you know, blowing up the street, but just enough to where like I can listen to music and no one's really worried about what the fuck and I have neighbors calling the police on me and shit. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I gotta have a theme park by me somewhere. I don't know. I'm trying to look for a new place to move. I just don't know where.
Walk out your house and it's like
it's lit out there. Yeah. Like, people are standing outside like here. People are not standing outside unless you like in like certain neighborhoods. People just aren't standing outside.
And you gotta drive everywhere.
Yeah, you gotta drive everywhere. In New York, everything's walking distance. Like, I hear some people don't even have cars, so they like 21 or like yeah. You don't need a car.
No, you don't. Get the train, bro. It's easier.
Yeah.
I think that one did in the backyard.
Bro, these niggas spending money. I love the color. Like, that would go good. Like, that shit would go good with what Kai has on now. Like, it gotta be plain. Because those shoes is the main character. Those shoes is the main character.
Like hitting people up, I don't know.
Oh, yeah.
I'm pretty sure we'll
cross
paths soon, bro.
What
is that so far?
I'm dying, bro. I don't know what you got, bro. Cause it's a lot.
Yeah, I got this. Then I got another chrome beanie.
Okay, yeah, we got the chrome beanie right there.
Okay. Bro, I ain't gonna lie, bro. It's looking like I'm not gonna be wearing no shorts.
Did y'all check the weather?
The weather gonna be like a little rainy.
Yeah, it might rain.
No, during the day might be a little rainy.
Nah, I ain't gonna lie. I'm about to say Miami, it'd be like it'll rain in certain spots.
But the hot. In certain spots, I think that's what it is.
Nah, during the day when you show, I check the weather.
With a white tee.
Yeah, you be wrong with that.
I just know niggas gonna have shorts. I wanna have shorts, bro. Cause I need shorts.
We got a bunch of these shorts. They might just go with a white tee.
I think I know why. Nigga, use a window. Yeah, they remixed that bitch. I heard it. I heard the sample in that, ho. I heard the sample in that, bitch.
What's the nice?
Yeah,
so you'll probably want to go put the 80 we have in the warehouse.
You a window shopper. Mad at me, I think I know why. Nigga, use a window shopper. When you see me, bye-bye. When I ride by, now I'm only watching cop. The Louisville slide. When your girl took apple pie, yeah, sweetie. Sweetie. Yeah, you know my niggas around me, yeah, we eating. Yeah, you know we really in this shit and we beasting. You know we eating good, bitch, we feasting. Yeah, you know me, it's only the phones. You know I smoke OG. It's cold in this world, it get lonely. Bitch, I'm like Kobe. I'm shooting shot, but where the boot?
Yeah.
I like the slides. The slides is fire.
You could get by, you could get by if you got like a white tee.
Yeah, that's calm. You be alright with those.
White tee or cream.
What hat is that?
Dang, too. No, why? Oh, this nigga going summer summery.
Together, it's like a shade thing, you know what I'm saying? Like, they just...
Yeah, now you're going 50 Shades of Orange.
Yeah, you're
now going like, 50 Shades of Brands. That's Prada, yeah. Gallery, and the fucking Louis slides, bro.
You be alright, bro.
Yeah, that's the Atlanta release.
Fine, it's an Atlanta shit. Fine, we're gonna taste this in Miami. We all just got some shit, bro.
Ooh, the Louis?
You're not going to y'all with sneakers, though.
I mean, I'm doing whatever the fuck I want to do. I like the slides though. The slides is hard. I don't give a fuck about the hat or the shorts. Shorts, I don't give a fuck about.
What?
You want to go Nike socks with these?
No.
No, he copped the gallery though. No, I have those.
I think that's what he means.
These niggas are spinning a bag, bro.
But it's just your bro.
Oh, hold on.
Oh, yeah.
I challenge.
Do 10.
You gotta do the real ones, though, not like the little short ones.
Yeah. Overhand, underhand.
Like, come on, let's get it.
I'm gonna go wide.
Let's go. There we go. Yo. Yeah.
Nah,
you going halfway through, my brother.
Nah, you got.
Come on, fam. Bam. There we go. Yeah, your chin gotta touch that bit. It don't count if your chin don't touch.
I
need one of them hoes, I can't lie.
I
need one of them bitches.
Let's do it.
I'd do that shit every day if I had it.
Do I have to beat him? Yes. Go do 10. Oh, do I have to go 10? Yeah, do I have to go
10? Oh, shit, my fucking laptop looked like that.
I feel like you could do...
Alright, try to do them as much as you can.
If I beat it, just video.
Pull up bar and
it's crazy. But Pat, you want to go or you want to choose who he go against?
Bro, don't let the old life fool you, bro.
Whatever.
It's probably
much. But this nigga probably like...
Go ahead, wait in the morning, Josh.
He probably about to rip off his shit. He's going to be
well ripped.
Bro, John, Pat, come on. Let's see how much Pat can do. At the Matra, I got... Oh, so what's the game?
No deal. There's no deal. He got
it. If you win, what do you want us to do?
Shit, give me this whole store.
Type shit.
Discount.
Oh, some shit.
How much
give
discount?
Give him a good deal.
A good deal or some shit.
Because you know, if he got the Louis Vuitton Forces, so we can do a good deal.
All right.
Let's do something.
If we win.
Yeah. If you win, I'm going to buy a mystery box.
5%, you know, how many pull-ups you do?
No, you got to do as much as you can. Yeah. And if I pass it, then that's the deal.
Right, yeah.
That's good. Deal. All right. Lock.
Hey, hold on.
Show me quick 30. Let's go.
Oh,
one.
Hey.
He's in his wall right now.
Come on.
You're going.
Come on, the shop is on the line, Pat.
Bow. Bow, you got it.
Yeah.
You got one more. You got one more.
Let's go, Pat. Ugh. Do it for the two. Do it for the two.
You got it. You got it.
Let's go, Pat.
You trying to get 16.
Oh. 15.
Yo, Pat has the will of a lion.
Bro, I'm trying to tell you, bro.
Wait. We going
15, how many you think you can do, chat? How many you think I can do? No bullshit?
One,
two, three, four.
Don't let the momentum fool you.
Come on, 30 more.
My son wants some LVs. Nah, don't make him lie.
I feel like I can do a good 17. There we go. He said, fuck. Yeah, I ain't struggle for nada. Nigga didn't know what was going on.
Hold on. It's definitely harder that way.
Yeah. Is it?
So did he run it back? Nah, it's his choice.
You want to run it back?
This way, definitely.
Wait, there's no way he's going to Nah,
I think it's damn near the same.
Me versus Pat. It got to be the same. It's the same. It's just about, that shit is just about what you want to build.
So what are we doing? Pat look like he's not trying to say. He's like,
said, fuck, bro. I fucked up.
I'm about to get in trouble.
Hey, next episode, Pat gonna take the whole challenge. You're gonna be so hard. Crazy.
You gotta do one hand and kiss one hand.
Next episode's gonna be a basketball hoop rail.
Nah, pull ups is fire, bro. That's a good challenge.
That is a good challenge.
Go outside and do it.
Yeah. Open up your light brown eyes. Said I love you when you're crazy, how my words might lie.
I'm telling you, bro, I want to rock with whoever the fuck.
This ain't what you want. I don't know how I'm not tired of that song yet.
Anything you do is going to be done by
me. I've heard this song so many fucking times and I'm not over it.
White, this is all white?
Those are five. Cool collect.
Artist right here? No hat? Or hit with the hat?
Hey, yeah, this ain't what you want, this ain't what you want,
I've been meaning to go to Icebox, man.
Make sure tonight, everything
goes.
Happy birthday.
Alright. Alright, y'all.
Thank you,
y'all. You're spinning that bag. Hey, now it's a fire vid. Y'all know how much I love clothes and shoes and shit. So that was kind of pretty. That was kind of fire for me. But why my shit, like, I'm trying to charge my shit. My shit lasted. What? So we've been on this for 2 hours. So now I realize on OBS, my shit only lasts about 2 hours. My shit only lasts about 2 hours before my shit about to cut the fuck out. No bullshit. 2 hours, that's all my shit can deal with. I gotta fucking pee. Fuck. It's this one. Alright, I'm gonna leave y'all.
driving really, yo. It's a NASCAR, driving really fast. It's a, yo, yo, ay, yo, yo, ay. And I love them, boy, it's sad. 30 racks for acapellas. I had to beat and do the math. I got hoes that want me sober and some want me for my cash. I felt slow up in a rover, but she really scared of cats. My homies crack, cause I balance it with rap. Check my stature, I can't be with rats. Feel the rapture, I've been acting bad. I'm the one, just for sake. Say I love you and it's pure, but I know you off of takes. Treat the 30s like it cured. It kick in, I'm really safe. She come back, it probably kill me, but I fucked up friend for safety. Hey, yo, fuck a foreign, I like muscle like my dad. Get through torn, I just raced another bad. Treat a foreign like a Chevy, I just add. NASCAR, you driving really fast. She like bad boys, Diddy with the cash. I want clean lean, need it really bad. Okay.
Yo, alright. This phone said it was fully charged, but for some reason it's still not turning on. I don't know how to I don't know how to turn these phones on, bro. How the fuck do you turn this shit on? Been charging for 2 hours. Bro, I don't know how to turn any of these motherfuckers on, bro. How the fuck do you turn this shit on? Bro. I don't know. Shit said it was fully charged. Okay. Hello. Hello to you too. Bro. So you're saying, what do you mean power off? Turn it on. So it gotta be fully charged. There's no way it has to be fully charged to be turned on. You're bullshit. Okay, there we go. There we go. We got motion. There we go. Oh my God. Yo. Look at this me in a fucking varsity jacket. Hold on. Can y'all even see that? Hold on. Y'all can't even see that. Oh my god. Oh my god, y'all can't, y'all literally can't see that. Oh my god. Bro. Hold on. It says 17 new bubbles. What the fuck does that mean? Looking for service. Unlock. How do you use this phone? If you don't know, if you weren't watching the beginning of my streams, I found my old phone and I'm trying to use it. Look at me. Look at me. Damn it. So much glare. Damn it. It's too much glare, bro. I can't see shit. I don't know how to open this phone, though. Okay. There we go. Sidekick bullshit. How do I use this shit? Voicemails. Oh my god, I have 6 voicemails? Contacts. Who's in my contacts? Looking for service. Okay. Home. Bro, how the fuck do you insert? Oh, there's no memory card. Okay, there's no memory card, so this probably ain't shit on here. But for some, what the fuck? I keep pressing shit, but it just keeps going to the home thing. But it says I have 10 text messages. How the fuck do you go? So you move down with this? Is it touchscreen? Yo, what in the fuck? I do not know how to use this shit, bro. Let's take a picture. Can we take a picture? No, it keeps saying I need a memory card. No, bro, stop. I don't know how to use this shit, bro. Because anytime I click on something, it either goes to, like... Okay, fine. Call. I don't want to call anybody. How the fuck do you scroll down? This shit is so weird. Okay. Camera. Enter. In memory. Wait, what? Camera. In memory. In phone memory is full. Delete files. Why did it say it so fast to where I couldn't read it? That's really weird. Alright, what photos do I have then? You said I don't have a memory card, but yet I have photos. And I can't click on them? Like, how the fuck do you use this goddamn phone? Text messages. Holy fuck. Yo, this is crazy. I can't turn up. I don't know if y'all can see this. Fuck. It's too much glare. Can y'all see? Damn. There's too much glare, bro. Oh my god. What is up with this phone? Okay, first text message says it's from Jacob. It says, at the age of 3, it's... What time is second period over? Smiley. at the age of 3, it's, I don't know what the fuck that means, but shout out to Jacob. From Saturday, April 12th, 2011. Then I got, hold on, I got MTV sees photos of Lil Wayne, I Am Still Music concert in New York. I went to that concert, not in New York, but in Dallas. I went to the I Am Still Music tour, and I went to American Airlines Center. Why am I getting text messages from MTV? I don't know. MTV Twilight Eclipse and Social Network get the auto-tune treatment. Watch. I don't know what the fuck that means. Julian, what's up? I didn't text back. On March 13th, 2013. Marciella said hey on March 13th, 2011. I said nothing. This is weird. Bro, this is like 12 years ago. I got a random hey from a 214 number. Didn't text back. I'm great at not texting people back. A 972 number. Hey, what's up? Oh, this was someone I was talking to. Because they say, hey, what's up? And then they say, good morning, love. After that. And I still didn't text back. Okay. And then I got a 901 number. Can y'all see that? You said, where the party's at? Nigga, I wouldn't know the fuck. This is weird. Giselle, I know who that is, actually. With a hey. I think I know that. I don't actually, I don't know. With a hi, with a H-E-Y-Y winky face. Alyssa. Bay? Question mark? Heart. Aw, I was too, babe. I was thinking about you all day today, babe. Sad face, sad face. I can tell. You're texting back slow. Trying to fix my F-O-N phone. I broke the screen. Sad face. Heartbreak. Tee-hee, I have a headache. I'm sorry. I'm confusing. That's cool. Watching Pulse? Watching the Grammys. You, hee-hee. What you dern, babe? She spelled dern, D-U-R-N, dern. What's up, babe? Hey, morning, gorgeous. Ooh-wee, bacon, heart. What the fuck? Eating because I'm fat, heart, ha-ha. I'm eating too. Weird face, and you're not fat. Yo, what was I on, bro? Good morning, honey bun. Good morning, beautiful. I love that today is Friday. I know, hee hee. Going to the mall. Who the fuck is Alyssa? I dated somebody named Alyssa? Ain't gonna lie, Alyssa, if you watching this, what is this? Alright, I'm coming. Ha ha. Yay, heart face. I mean, heart. Hee hee. I'd be kissing all over you. Me trying to riz. I'm a crash, hun. Night, honey. Come over, please. What are these text messages? Babe, don't be sad. Shut up. They suck. I hate the Cowboys. Who the fuck is Alyssa? Give me a kiss. What are these? I like you. Did I send a fucking photo? Is this a photo of me? Can I open this? Hold on. Oh my goodness. This is a photo I done sent to somebody and... Hold on. Wait. I sent another one. Hopefully, I don't think I sent dick pics back then. I don't think that's not what I was doing. Hopefully. I don't remember, if I'm being honest. That is crazy. What are these photos? Let me send... It's another... Whoa, I'm not showing that. That is crazy. It's nothing bad. It's just... That's a terrible photo of me. Bro, I do not remember. She sent a photo of herself. I don't remember talking to this girl. It's a photo with no face. I don't think I was sending, like, news. I don't think I was doing anything crazy. Both photos are not of her face, by the way. She sent me two photos not of her face. She sent me three photos not of her face. She's pretty. She looks pretty cute, though. Is that weird? Cause that's a no. I'm not gonna say it. I'm not gonna say nothing. That's crazy. Okay, we're moving on. Alexis. Hey, Sean. Didn't text back. 214 number. Hey, bro. You wanna do me a favor? You wanna do a favor with me? No homo. You want to do a favor with me? No homo. Are you high? Ha ha ha. Is that why you went to the restroom so long? Hey, bro, you want to do... I don't know who the fuck that is. Tori, what are you doing for spring break? I didn't text back. Dude, this is crazy. Raquel... Hearts, March 7th, 2011. This is so weird. Mary, hey, I didn't text back. What's up with me not texting back? Bree. Who is the girl? Question mark. Don't listen to him. He's being an ass right now. Ugh, Sean, just don't reply to him. Yo. Okay, you sent a forward message. This is the homie Fonzie. Alfonso. Oh, I know. Oh, okay. I know what Bree this is. That's crazy. Alfonso. Fonzie was one of my good friends in high school. He was probably one of my best friends. I had another best friend named Steven. Alfonso sent Saturday, March 5th, 2011. Fuck you, Sean. He says, wait, hold on. Hold on. I got the light on me. I guess I need the light on me. It says, I'm sorry, it's dark. It says, hold on. It says, fuck you, Sean. Bree told me what you said. You're not a friend to me. I can't believe you, man. What did I do? Am I a terrible friend? What did I do? My phone screwed up. Don't listen to the message. Yo, what kind of drama was I going? What kind of drama was I in? La Brea. What you doing? I didn't text back. Maybe I shouldn't be saying the names on here. 469 number. Hey, so what's good? What's good? Oh, I'm not reading that out loud. That's crazy. What the fuck I had going on? I think I was being a little horny fuck back then. There's a lot of horny messages in here that I'm not gonna say. Okay. So Somebody wrote me on Facebook. I guess I was going crazy on Facebook at the time. Hang on, this is insane. Okay. Oh my goodness. This shit is crazy. Mad numbers from Facebook. Text me. You need to call me tonight or whenever you get your phone. Something happened today. Hey, cuteness. Heart face. I got Hot Topic messages. Babe, call me. I love you too. Babe, I was in a shower. Call me. Cotton ball scrubber. I think I know who this is. But this is crazy. Sending girls the same picture is crazy. Telling bitches I love you and shit. This is insane. Am I bro? What the fuck was going on with me? I ain't gonna lie, this shit is wild. Now I'm just damn near curious. I was a little horny little bitch. Nick. Oh, that's the homie. Hurry up, ho. How is it? I hate your friend. Sound like some shit that nigga was a. Who the fuck? Odysseus? Hey, Emily. What did Emily say? Emily. Hey. She said hey 4 times and I didn't send anything back. Bro, 2011 must have been. I don't remember, bro. I spent all my time smoking mad weed, so I don't remember any of this shit. Yeah, this is crazy. Mom, please check the office for any packages. We should have our phones today. Come help me with the groceries. You want pancakes and eggs. Yo, shout out to moms, yo. W moms, bro. That's a real message, by the way. Hey, really? I was thinking about you. Shut up. Okay. Nothing too crazy on this phone, but like, it's a lot of me like bullshitting with women, or girls actually. I can tell. So I've said I love you to like 4 different bitches, which is insane. All right, now I can. Okay, maybe I was going through my whole phase. Don, what the fuck is? What's good, bro? Okay. I think I was trying to buy some weed. Hey, handsome. I haven't talked to you because I didn't have my phone for a while. Okay. Somebody wrote on my Facebook wall. Hey, sorry I didn't text, but I lost my phone and I don't know when I'm getting another one. Oh, that bitch was capping. I felt like that bitch was capping. I feel like that's what people used to say. Hey, you got a hat I can borrow today? Shout out to Michael. That nigga added me on Facebook like 2 weeks ago. So that's kind of crazy. Hey, Kit Kat. You got a hat. This thing called me Kit Kat. Alright. But there's a lot of shit on here. What the fuck? Hey, do you want to talk on the phone for a little bit? Hey, baby. I love it. Me sending the same photo to another woman. Holy sheesh. Bro, why was I so dumb back then? I wasn't even talking about shit either. No game, no riz. That's crazy. I don't want to go through the rest of it. I'm tired of looking at it. It was a lot, a whole lot of dollar. That's crazy. No, that's crazy. All right, I'm back on another video. Let's get into it. Oh. Oh, wait, hold on. There's no way we just got another fucking follower. XDSUFFY103. XDScruffy103 just followed me at 3:16 p.m. It is now 3:45. I'm sorry I missed your follow. I appreciate you. I thank you. That is my... Yo. I didn't see it. I'm sorry. I was on my bullshit. I didn't see it. But I appreciate you, my dude, my girl. I appreciate it. I fuck with you. I appreciate the follow. That's what's up. That's crazy. And I told y'all, if I get 10 followers, I'm doing a 24 hour. It's really nothing for me to do a 24 hour. But I want to have a goal in mind. I don't want to just do it just to do it. So when I get 10 followers, you know what I'm saying? You watching this, you watching me, follow the fuck up. Comment, look at my other social medias, follow on that bullshit too. You know what I'm saying? That's what's up though. I got another follower today. That's kind of cool. You know what I'm saying? Why does it still say 8 though? Who the fuck unfollowed me? Because I had 8 followers. You know what? I don't care. I don't know what this video is. I seen some skateboarding, I seen some cool shit. So we're going to watch it. A Day with the Homies, Agriculture, Devontae Jolly. Never seen this video, never heard this nigga's name, but I'm gonna watch this shit. Anyways. My shit's not charging. Why is it not charging? The whole time? Oh my god, my shit could have died. My shit's on 15%, you son of a bitch. God damn it. Bro, I need a longer cable cord, bro. It's just too short. Anyways. We back and we back. But again, thank you for the follow, my boy. This nigga's pulling up in Porsches? This nigga's got emotion. They with the homies. What kind of homies you got? That's the homies I'm trying to, you know what I'm saying? Type shit.
Man, we at the Roosevelt right here in Hollywood.
You feel Talk me? To me.
About to get right.
Yeah, I seen her at
some brunch
I
lunch.
Some brunch lunch. It's about that time too. It's 3:47.
He just mad. He not on camera right now.
He said I don't want security to come over here and say anything, but he would be the one to tell security to come over here and say something to us. So it's like, what is wrong? Like
that rich nigga shit.
I need your E30 for 100 cash. He said, nah, I need 120.
People that have those cars, like, love that car. Like, it's not even a money thing, low-key. He know, that's why he said.
I crashed my shit, and I was like,
salvage title.
I gotta get another one, bro.
Got a salvage
title? I gotta get another one, bro. Because my shit got state repped, and I didn't drive it for 4 years. I had it for 10 days. And then somebody ran in, and they cut me off, total. And then BMW came in, like,
sweet. I said, got you.
We got you.
They took care of it?
Yeah.
You didn't see the video?
Oh my god.
They redid a whole new
thing. Oh, these niggas got money. This nigga talking about Porsches and BMs. I don't know who these niggas are. I ain't gonna cap. I just seen like the thumbnail and it intrigued me. So now I'm.
Hey, let them know I got a BMW.
Because I had the BMW. It was my second car, my E30 that was crashed. Was my second car I ever got when I was like 21. No, I got it when I was 20.
I ain't gonna lie. I don't have a car.
Yeah, before
I can't afford a car at the moment. I ain't got one. I'm an everyday working man. I just got a new job 2 weeks ago. Nigga. I just got my check last Friday. Fuck. Or yesterday.
David Hockney.
Spent that bitch on bills. Fuck.
Just this? Yeah, but it's crazy because it's like, you can't take the...
But I'm not hating. Shout out to these successful young black brothers.
Art crazy. It's crazy. Yeah, art is
crazy. It'd be a low-ass piece.
crazy amounts of money.
But it's just like, amazing, who did it? It's like, yeah, that's what sets the value.
Oh, man, I can't even do this.
Oh, I love dirt bikes, bro. I gotta give me a dirt bike, bro. Oh, that bitch is fire.
Damn, I just blew my tire apart.
There's damn. Next to an In-N-Out. That's the most California shit I've ever seen in my life. Oh my god, that looks so fun. Chad, if I ever get some real money, tell me to buy a fucking dirt bike. Actually, you won't have to tell me. That's the first thing I'm buying. I probably won't even get a car. I'll just buy a dirt bike. Hey, he said, watch out, my boy. Gone.
Yeah, that nigga hit me, bro. It would have been a wrap.
Day with the homies over.
You're not homies no more. Day with the ops. Day with the ops.
Oh, okay, Ben. What we talking about? What you got? What you got, my boy?
What you grabbing?
I don't know. What you got?
Nosy ass. Going through all my shit.
I'm nosy too. Nigga, what you sitting at me?
Nigga like me trying to come up all the time.
Hey, I didn't know you was broke. Just say that.
I ain't broke. I ain't broke.
Yeah, just say that.
I'm broke.
I just started this job.
I got no monies. I spent money on my phone bill, rent. Nigga, bought some groceries. Nigga, I got enough money, you know what I'm saying, for some Ubers. Shit. I got survival. What I got for next 2 weeks. Fuck is you talking about? I need a skateboard, bro.
Hey, you don't need to be like me, because once you get into toys, you don't have no more money. You always got a broken car. You got like dirt. Yeah, you got 3 bikes. That's cool. But what else you got? Pebbles.
This shit's nice as fuck, dude.
The ones you have for like 3-4 years. Because like, you only wear them. No, I'm just saying, like, that's how I do certain dunks. Yeah. Like, certain dunks, I only wear them.
Yeah.
So I could, like, keep wearing them, you know?
Look at that shit. Look at that shit.
That's hard.
Fire.
Look like a JPEG, huh? Color wheel.
I like those. Those are clean.
He had an off-white shirt on. Ooh.
He got that shit on, man. He got that shiznit on. Yeah, Lindsay not here, so it's looking like we're going to have to wait in the line, and I'm not down for that.
To grab glasses? At Kith? Are you serious?
Yeah, I'm a grown man. I never wait in line. I skipped the line. Because I'm childish.
It's just I had different brands. I wanted the brands to line up. You feel me? I didn't want that to collide too much. I wanted it to make sense.
Where the fuck are they at?
Like, who am I listening to?
They look like some LA California ass niggas.
What glasses you getting?
Huh? I'm telling you, dude. That's crap.
Bro, this is fucking crazy. Look at this shit, bro. They just pulled up.
That bitch is insane. Old school Porsche. I think that's a 9-2, right?
She was like, what you doing in Hollywood? She checked my location.
She said, what you on?
What you doing, Mr. Hollywood?
Hey, hey, yeah, 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 yeah. Now we in this bitch. Now we got motion. Now we in this bitch. Now we got motion. You bitch fell in love. I ain't give her potion. Now she feeling man. Yo. Hey. Yo. In the dunks too? Oh, it was nice. Oh, my bad. My bad. Hey. Whipping. Dipping. Tripping. Now I'm in sipping. Now I'm feeling different. This really is a day with the homies type shit. Security guard talking shit. Fuck out of my face, pussy. There we go. There we go. His song. Yo. Fish camera lens. Always fire. Hey, man. If you ain't this happy living your life, doing what the fuck you want to do in 2023, I don't know what the fuck you doing. These niggas seem like they chilling. I see no stress. Skating, chilling, Porsches, BMWs.
Yeah, how you
doing, bro? You alright?
I'm doing good.
The fuck is Godspeed?
Part, bro. Thank you.
I don't know who these niggas are. All right. Good day. I really don't.
Wow. Shout out Godspeed, man. Yeah.
I don't know who that is.
It was on Godspeed.
Yes, sir.
Oh, shit.
Peace, bro.
You too, bro.
I don't know. I don't know.
To the ledge spot, and there's no ledge. There's no ledge. Where they took the ledge?
Where they took the ledge is that? Them shits was heavy, too.
Damn, I miss skating.
That shit gone.
Shit, my bad.
Good thing I caught your ass.
No, I got fucking big ass.
What the fuck? Hey, it's crazy when you go to a spot and the whole spot is gone.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? We got Jolly behind the lens, man. Stop playing with that man. King Jolly, man.
Yes, sir.
Jolly didn't film it.
Hey.
I don't know who did it. Ain't it, though.
Hey.
Chilling with the Brodies.
Hey, Jolly better.
Oh, God, you hear what I said?
Jolly better.
See it.
Come on, man.
You say you're me?
Get your shit right now, bro. Get your shit right now.
Yes, sir.
Say your shit so I can leak it, man.
It is.
I'm about to put that bitch on the store and be like, hey, gas giant.
Damn, I miss California, bro.
It's 1-800.
I miss that California air. All that smog.
How do you put a .com in the phone?
All that traffic. I miss it.
That's some new shit.
Gas giant CEO right here, yo.
No, I'm saying, like, to call somebody.
Oh, no.
I might go back this year. I don't know.
Yeah. You don't got to do extra work.
Yeah, true. Oh, who the fuck called me?
Gas giant CEO.
Oh, that's you. Hello?
Who called me? Hey, he just declined it right in front of your face.
Yeah. Guys, well, I don't want to talk to him.
Yeah, decline that shit right in the homie's face.
Hey, no, it's like when you see somebody walking across the street and you call them and you see them look at their phone.
And
these niggas chatting. Fuck, I got going on. That Porsche is clean though. Drop top.
My boy's in the front seat, knocked out.
You saw that?
Yeah, I filmed it.
For real?
Yeah. I started to film it. The light.
That bitch look so chill with the red seats too.
I got his iPhone though.
Fuck.
Man, I was tired. Why didn't y'all say that?
I feel it. Nah.
That bitch crazy.
Cheeseburgers, man.
Nah, two phones, you got it.
Nah, get your leg up the other way. The other way.
Hey, yo.
Real quick. Look real quick.
Okay.
This way.
Look to Shoddy. He worried. Actually, he worried about that tree.
But what did these niggas do?
He's I ain't trusting this bridge.
Bro, that tree is strong. Look at it. It's strong, but nigga, you got it.
I don't know what these niggas do. I ain't gonna cap. Yo, it's okay. Damn, I miss skating with the homies. I ain't gonna cap. I miss all my little skater friends. Is skating just like some California shit? Cause everyone I knew from California just had a skateboard. Even if you really didn't skate like that, you had a skateboard. I think California is just like a skating ass state.
I mean, if you don't stop, it's fun.
Cause I'm in Texas right now and people skate, but like it's not like a culture. Like, skating in California, that's like a culture. Like, that's something you do. Like, you know what I'm saying? You wake up early in the morning on your day off from school, nigga, you're skating. Late night, you know what I'm saying? You skating. You know what I'm saying? The same shit as you would ask the homie to play basketball or some shit. It's Louisiana. Oh, nah, that hill's kind of crazy.
See, I ate it. I ain't gonna lie.
You fell?
I ate it. Look.
Let me see. Turn around.
How? Where?
I let the bottom turn, and then went into the.
His pants is fire, though.
Landed in the grass.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but I did it, dude.
Oh yeah, that nigga from Louisiana.
In the trunk, I was saying, I was like, whose shoes are these? Like, they getting tossed because of boards.
Them shoes is pretty fire, though.
I didn't care either. They was looking at me.
put the shoe, put the boards on top too. I was like, damn, nigga, they're my shoes. Y'all not giving a fuck about.
That's a fire photo.
Art, are we good?
Yeah, that's fire.
I got hella, All
right, we good, Let's get it.
That's a wrap. And that's a wrap. Homie should be CEO.
Everyone needs to be CEOs, bro. Everyone should have their own shit.
Facts.
YouTube.
Facts.
Sock company, whatever it is.
Facts.
Start your own shit.
Facts.
And run it up.
Facts.
If you pass it on, you don't own it.
Exactly. Come on now.
I agree. Start your own shit. You know what I'm saying? Start your own shit. Alright. That was a cool little, you know what I'm saying? That was a cool little, you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna start a clothing business in a second. Y'all keep fucking with me. Cause this bitch is plain. I put my signature in this, but you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna start my own clothing business. I don't give a fuck. I'm gonna start a bunch of shit. All right, but what we on to next? Let's matter of fact, what time is 4? Fuck. All right, I'll give y'all like another hour, cause then by 5 I gotta. I'm gonna have to dip. So let's find a few like compy little vids we can watch. Ain't gonna lie, I'm hungry. So should we just get into some food videos? Ah, the Bam Margera. Oh, this is a good video. Okay, we're gonna start this video. I'm not gonna finish this whole thing, but I, you know, and it's only 43 minutes. We can for sure finish that in one session. Because I know for a fact I'm not going to finish that. And I don't even want to get into it. Because I know I'm not going to finish this shit. Random movie clip. Are we getting into trailers? Shit, I guess we are. Fuck. I guess we're gonna get into some trailers. So? All right, first trailer we're watching, not gonna bullshit, because it comes out today, we're watching The Last of Us. All right, that is what we are watching, because it literally comes out today, and I'm gonna watch it. I don't even know what time it comes out, but it's today, so we're gonna watch this.
If you don't think there's hope for the world, why bother going on?
You haven't seen the world. So you don't know. You keep going for family.
I'm not family.
No. You're cargo.
Why are you so important?
Somewhere out west, they're working on a cure. I think what really impressed them was the fact that I didn't turn into a monster.
If she so much as twitches. Don't.
It's okay.
Chernobyl. Acclaimed video game, which I'd never finished, by the way.
Do what I say when I say it. Got any advice on the best way west?
Yeah, go east. You've come this far, then you know what's out there.
You're not gonna scare us.
Scared him?
You have a greater purpose than any of us could have ever imagined.
Be careful who you put your faith in.
You might not be her father.
You trust me?
Wow, I got chills. Holy fuck, that shit is gonna be good. Holy fucking shish kebab, bro. That is insane. Nah, no bullshit. That's gonna be good. That's gonna be fucking good. That's gonna be a good fucking show, bro. Okay. Okay, Skyfall came out with an official trailer. Last time was a teaser and ain't show us shit. Oh fuck, Skyfall's another one, bro. Hold on. Skyfall's another. Oh, hold on. Skyfall's another one, bro. Skyfall's one of them shows, bro. You gotta tune in, bro. You just got to. It's one of them shows, bro. Hold on. Bro, why does it do that? Like, why does it move? It's fine. Am I here playing? Whatever. Okay.
Franklin, what do you want?
I want to marry V. Have this baby. I want the life I was so close to having, I could taste it. Till they ripped it away.
You were supposed to be out. Out.
I built an empire. Starting back in zero. That ain't gonna happen. We know exactly who we dealing with.
I want to see him in something else. It's gonna get real bad for you. I've heard the main character's in name. Damien, I think.
Swallow your pride and make peace with your family. Because this isn't good for anyone.
Told you the gloves had to come off. Franklin is going to war.
He's R.I.P.
to bring this entire operation crashing down.
Cream, get the money.
CIA has been selling cocaine in the United States.
Even after all of this, you want to think America still cares about you.
It ever occur to you this is exactly what they want? For us to wipe each other out?
My back is against the wall. And exit the terms of the course of the rest of our lives. This is about survival.
Do it. End this shit right now.
Damn. Oh my goodness. February? Bro, the end of February? Fuck me, bro. It's like, it's more than a month away. For about a month. Oh, man, that's gonna be good too. I ain't gonna care. I'm heavily invested into that show. At first, I think when it came out, I watched maybe like 2 episodes, and then I stopped watching, and then I all of a sudden just like sped run, watched the whole thing, all the seasons and shit, and I just got mad into it. It's a hell of a show. Hell of a show. Okay, and then the last is Ant-Man. I only seen the first Ant-Man. I don't know how many Ant-Mans there is. I've only seen the first one, so. But I want to watch it just because we got it. So. Yeah.
You're an interesting man. Scott Lang. You're an Avenger. You have a daughter. But you've lost a lot of time, like me. We can help each other with that. Who are you? I'm the man who can give you the one thing you want.
What's that?
Time.
He can rewrite existence and shatter timelines. You cannot trust him.
I don't care who this guy is. I just lost so much. He can give us a second chance.
That's how this 2 days.
Let me make this easy for you. You will bring me what I need. Or everything you call a life will end.
This is all my fault.
You may not want her to watch this.
We had a deal.
You could win.
I don't have to win. We both just have to lose. I'm sorry, Cassie.
It looks okay. I don't know if I'm gonna see it though. I don't know, but it looks alright. Like, you know what I'm saying? I wouldn't say it looks like a bad movie, but does it look like a movie I'm necessarily interested in? Meh. Being honest, meh. But yeah. So how y'all feel about this? About this, you know what I'm saying?
Lord
stream.
I'm about to bust.
Hey, man. That's all I need to know. Shit. Let me know what's going on with you. My boy. Random movie clip time, because we're already on to trailers. Yeah, no, I love James Bond. Stop fucking with me. Small blind, big blind.
That's to you. If that was for luck, you're 2 hours late.
200 to you.
$5,000. I wouldn't be good at gambling, bro.
Check.
Check to you, sir.
All in. No way. $20,000.
Yeah, he fucked up with this one. Yeah, I'm gonna need that, my boy. Yeah, I'm taking your bitch too. The fuck is you talking about? Yo, James Bond be on that shit, boy. James Bond be on that shit. See, this nigga upset. Hey, man. Hey, no one told you to bet your car. Nobody. And this bitch, her little fine ass. What is my god, man? You going? Yes, sir. Pull up on that foreign. Pull up on me in the foreign. If it ain't foreign, then it's boring.
My mistake.
Can I get you left home?
That would really send him over the edge. I'm afraid I'm not that cruel.
Well, perhaps you just had a practice.
Yeah, bitch. Yeah.
Perhaps.
Yeah, perhaps, huh? My place.
Your place.
Yeah, my place.
Is it close?
Get in. Okay, okay, with the eye contact. Oh, this bitch said hesitate. I swear, Is it close? You want to know how close? Guess how close. Guess how close we is. We here. Yeah, got this. If you make a laugh and jiggle, you look at guys jiggle. Yo, James Bond be on that shit though. James Bond be on that. Is there another like older clip of James Bond I can watch? I'm actually kind of curious. Aston Martin versus Ferrari. Okay, this is an older one. Oh, this is Pierce Bronson. I don't even know what year this was. Probably early 2000s.
Who's that?
The next call.
Hello. Ferrari so clean. Ferrari F355. That bitch is clean, bro. You can hear that engine too. This music is ridiculous. Sounds like some 90, like 2002, 2001 type shit. The fuck? How does nigga whole bike fall off? Okay.
As you can see, I have no problem with female authority.
James, you're incorrigible. What am I going to do with you?
Yo, James Bond. Yo, James Bond be on that shit, bro. I'm telling you. Hey, man. You see why I love James Bond as a little kid, bro? I'm telling you. Hey, man. You see why I love James Bond as a kid, bro? What in the fuck? Mid race, nigga pull out a bottle of champagne and start kissing bitches. Yes, and mid race in the middle of nowhere. That's crazy. All right. Actually, I want to look at this other Ferrari. Why we looking at cars? Cause I seen this video and I've never watched it, so now we about to watch it. Get out your way. That's gonna hit me with an ad. I said, bitch, you bet not. Oh my god, dude, that red is so, bro. I don't even like red like that, but sheesh. That bitch is beautiful. Ferrari's so fucking iconic, it's ridiculous. You ever want to lick a car? No? Listen to me right now. Cause I...
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Whew. Okay, holy fuck. Alright, let's finish this video before I actually... Because good lord. I'm about to bust the nut. Was that porn? I I just I don't know how I feel about that. I just I feel
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Oh, Jesus Christ, you and me both, buddy. Holy fuck. Whew. Do anyone feel instant sweat and regret? No? Holy fuck. Oh my god. My dick is hard. I don't give a fuck what you got. Shit. Sheesh. I gotta move on to something else. Cause Lord have mercy, I am about to bust. Okay, hold on. Oh shit. Hold on. Wait, that's not it. It's not it. It's this one. Nope, it's not that one. Nope. This one? There he is. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, we are moving on to what is new on the news. We have a lot to talk about, a lot to go through. First off is government reveals more UFO sightings. So, let's talk about it. Actually, let me move my... Well, I guess I'm okay right here, right? Okay. Apparently, the government is telling us they are revealing more UFO sightings, but yet still won't tell us who killed John F. Kennedy. Back to you, John.
This morning, U.S. intelligence agencies confirm hundreds of additional UAP sightings have been reported. UAP stands for Unidentified Aerial Phenomena, otherwise known as UFOs. The annual report on unidentified aerial phenomena now reveals 366 new close encounters since an agency was formed in 2021 to track them. That's more than double the number reported in the previous 17 years combined.
Oh my gosh, dude. Wow.
Officials say they can explain less than half those encounters. Usually a mix of drones, balloons, or birds. The rest remain a mystery.
Balloons.
Like this Navy pilot's video from 2004, showing a group of unknown aviators seemingly defying the laws of physics.
There's a whole fleet of them. Oh my gosh. They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots to the west.
Or this inexplicable run-in off the coast of California in 2015.
Whoa, it's getting close.
Pentagon officials say it's not time to call the men in black just yet.
Who are you? Really?
Really? I am just a figment of your imagination.
But they say it's crucial to track, investigate, and disclose reported incidents to help protect national security and safety for all Earthling flyers.
I think one of the key points in this report, you know, given the potential hazard that UAPs do present, notably there's been no reported collisions.
One reason for the spike in UFO sightings, officials say they've been working to destigmatize the topic in the name of safety. And more government agencies are working together to share information. Andrew, Christy?
Right, the truth is out there. Brittany Shepard joining us in New York from our Washington Bureau. Brittany, thank you.
Hi.
So, like,
it was moments like these, challenging the limits of physics, that raised potential security risks that were too big to ignore.
Gosh. They're all going against the wind. The wind's 120 knots to the west.
The military releasing this 2015 video.
Why are you all in my left ear, my dude? Why are you all in my left ear?
2 years ago, showing naval pilots off the coast of California completely.
I don't like it. I'm sorry. I can't. That's making me feel weird. I don't like it. I feel weird. I don't like it. Take it away. Fuck. So there's just UFO, there's two, so there's 366 UFO sightings, and there's just nobody just talking about, nobody talking about it, just nobody. Yeah, I mean, that's fine, I guess, but, you know, just nobody mentioning it whatsoever. Okay, whatever, that's fine, do your thing, I guess, whatever, fuck. Fucking losers. It's so weird. First of all, we all know aliens are real. We already know there's, we're not the only ones in our entire universe. The universe is fucking infinite and it keeps expanding. I'm not fucking dumb. I know what the fuck y'all are up to. Y'all are weirdos. It's alright.
15 people are dead after a mass shooting at a bar in South Africa.
Police said a group of armed men entered the tavern and started shooting at the patrons inside.
In July 2022, South Africa was rocked by a spate of bar shootings. 22 people were killed at three different bars in one weekend alone. In one shooting, the gunmen used AK-47s with more than 100 empty cartridges found at the scene. But how did they obtain such powerful guns? Some point the finger at what might be considered an unlikely source, the police.
South Africa's rising gun violence is largely driven by the trade of illegal guns on the black markets.
On average, 23 people are shot and killed in South Africa daily. Many of the weapons used are illegal, stolen from police stations or private security firms.
Well, more than 500 firearms were reportedly lost from the South African police services.
158 firearms, which were being stored at the Norwood SAP 13 store, have been stolen.
In January 2022, more than 150 guns were found to be missing from a single station in Johannesburg. Forensic evidence of these same weapons revealed them to be factoring in at crime scenes across the country.
Police are generally considered to be the most corrupt public institution in just about any country.
The illegal gun trade in South Africa, said to be both perpetuated and pursued by police, shows the blurred lines between policing and lawbreaking that are a reality all over the world. This is the business of crime. In this episode, we're looking at how corrupt cops can aid and abet criminals, continuing the cycle of crime and keeping themselves in the job.
Damn.
To start, it's important to understand the conditions and circumstances that foster corruption within a police force and allow it to thrive.
What feeds that is social dysfunction as well as limited economic opportunity. And then the exploitation of all of that by these gangs and criminal networks.
Bad cops don't come from nowhere. They're created because they're tolerated.
There are allegations that police, cartels, and gangs are working together.
In countries where there are high rates of killings by police or high rates of police corruption in general, it usually goes alongside inadequate laws, inequality, and human rights violations.
Honduras National Police arresting their former president at his home after the U.S. requested his extradition to the States to face drug trafficking and weapons charges.
Jeez. Governments lacking in trust and transparency, with politicians who are themselves corrupt, often contribute to a lawless environment.
Typically around, you know, areas where organized crime is incredibly active, or those organized crime networks have really found a way to infiltrate police structures. In South Africa and Brazil, where broadly within society there are issues, you know, whether it's in politics or in other arenas where there's corruption in and of itself, that's where policing, you know, institutions may become corrupted themselves.
In South Africa, police corruption today is impossible to divorce from the country's history of apartheid. In poor black communities in particular, cops still aren't readily trusted.
Your average police officer in South Africa is recruited from a community that's low income, that's under-resourced, and they themselves may not have chosen policing as their first profession. What that then does is open up a lot of doors and windows and opportunities for organized crime to approach police officers and say, do you want to make more money? Do you want to keep your family safer? You could do so by colluding with us, either to turn a blind eye or to make evidence disappear.
In 2016, former police colonel Christian Prinsloo pled guilty to a laundry list of charges, including racketeering and unlawful possession and sale of firearms.
Every weekend there is somebody dying. We don't know whether it's because of all these guns that was selling out to gangsters.
With the help of a colleague who worked in the police munitions hold, Christian Prinsloo was found to have stolen more than 2,000 firearms in police possession over 10 years, generating more than 2 million rand, or more than $100,000.
Ballistics have linked guns that he took from
money is the root of all evil.
To the murder of hundreds of people on the Cape Flats in particular, and the deaths of over 80 children.
The problem is far from confined to South Africa. In Brazil, the lines are even further blurred as police struggling to combat organized criminal groups instead cooperate with them to maintain control.
In Rio de Janeiro, this is actually like very common. Police has like a practice of seizing guns from the drug dealers and the militias and selling them back to the militias and drug dealers, maybe for a different group, a rival group.
Most militias have at least some members who are also serving officers. Illegal firearms are readily available, with the market controlled by corrupt military and police officers with connections to transnational criminal networks and gangs.
Faz parte da sacanagem que eu quero te dizer é o quê? Todo mundo quer ganhar um negocinho por fora, até os policiais, entendeu?
What are the secrets that
she's crazy.
I don't know.
Let me see your ID card.
Wait.
This is a world you will have to live in. There's no going back.
Trafficked. Interesting.
Firearms seized by police are often lost, misplaced, or stolen. In 2017, nearly 100 officers in Rio de Janeiro were arrested and charged with supplying powerful assault weapons and police intelligence to organized crime groups.
Damn.
O policial que trai o seu dever de ofício trai a sociedade a qual jurou defender.
I think one of the main issues as well in Brazil is a lack of accountability, around policing. I think because people in Brazil, like in South Africa, feel desperately unsafe, particularly in low-income communities. And so they've ceded an enormous amount of power to the police.
A police operation gets underway in the Alamo favela in Rio. They happen almost daily, and they're always violent.
But in the subsequent years, the alliance between organized crime and corrupt police in Rio has only strengthened, and violence has increased.
25 people, including a police officer, were killed in a ferocious gun battle.
In the first 4 months of 2020, Rio police killed 606 people, and that's by their own official count. Even Rio authorities have begun to acknowledge that large parts of the state are no longer in their control. But when the militia also has ties to city and state politicians, the rot is able to fester and spread.
It's not a dirty apple, nah? It's a rotten organization, nah? That is producing rotten apples everywhere. Police commanders, they show the number of people that they expelled from the police every year to justify that they are doing something. But they are not doing something because they are distributing blame. They are not responsibilizing the chain of command, understanding the organizational factors that are favoring police corruption and sometimes pushing officers towards police corruption. That's the worst thing.
So, how can we stop corrupt cops in their tracks? Sometimes it reflects a fundamental issue with how the police force is structured. Insufficient resourcing, for example, or inadequate training and pay. Sometimes the problem is bigger, going all the way up to the top of the force, the government, or both. Even laws can protect police officers and obstruct justice. The main cop combating corruption in South Africa was shot dead. Is this the risk of trying to address corruption?
Now, you'll remember that Kinnear, a top Cape Town anti-gang unit boss, was gunned down outside his home.
The consequences of reporting police corruption can be seriously hazardous. I mean, you know, if you're a senior police officer at a very high level, reporting corruption, it would not be difficult for the others to work out who it was who spilt the beans and would have to fear for their lives.
But as much as corruption is a structural issue, reflecting flaws in a system, it's also a human one. When even the lowest ranking cop has some power, the possibility of corruption is inevitable.
Bro. I don't know, bro. That shit's crazy, bro. Because the shit that's going on in Mexico right now is insane. The shit that's all the school shootings and mass shootings going on in America. And I don't know. I don't have an answer at all whatsoever. That shit's crazy. It's fucked
up.
There
is no peace.
But rest in peace to any lives that's been lost and shit like that. But I don't have the answer. I don't know what to tell you. Because I love guns. But at the same time, I'm not out here shooting people. I use it because it's a hobby I like to do. And it's for my own protection for my family. But at the same time, like, fuck, bro. This is living with nearly 100% inflation. What the fuck? Is that... What? Where is this?
Puedo pedir papel higiénico. Papel higiénico de 4, puré de tomate, sal, azúcar, después también detergente, lavandina, desodorante.
100% is insane. If it means what I think it means.
Trying to get pantry staples. But inflation in Argentina has soared to nearly 100%, so she can no longer afford them.
Argentina.
The way to get things is often going on Facebook to barter. Here it's called el trueque.
Ahí tengo foto. Todo para hombre. Yo trabajo en casas particulares por hora. Antes me alcanzaba, pero ahora por día tengo que hacer hasta 2-3 casas. Pero está que por lo que te pagan no te alcanza porque todo está caro.
So how does el trueque help you? How does it help your family?
Ahora lo hago, por ejemplo, 2 veces a la semana. Generalmente me salva de comprar lo que me hace falta cuando no tengo la plata. ¿Viste? Subimos lo que tenemos a las páginas de los grupos que hay muchísimos miembros, muchísimas, la mayoría son mujeres. Subimos lo que tenemos y pedimos lo que queremos pedir.
So what are the products that are most in demand in the groups? What do people need?
El azúcar.
Sugar.
La yerba, que aquí se usa yerba, todo el mundo toma mate, ¿viste? Galletitas
really?
Dulces para los chicos, fideos, porque ya no, es como que el fideo también se fue muy caro.
El trueque is something that helps you, but you also see it and you feel it as something that is to help others.
Es como que se hace una red, ¿viste? Se arma una red. Te sirve a vos y le sirve al otro. Quizás empieza como que una mano solidaria. Yo te ayudo y vos me ayudás. Sí.
People in Argentina know their way around an economic crisis.
Oh, yeah. True.
In the early 2000s, the economy collapsed.
I remember that.
Many turned to bartering clubs to get by. Things have bounced back since...
Yeah, I'm global, nigga. I paid attention.
...remained a persistent problem. And now it's at its highest in more than 30 years.
Jeez.
There's no one reason for this, but a major problem is that the government spends more than it has. To keep up, it borrows or prints more money, which devalues a currency. This administration...
Which is what the U.S. government is doing, by the way, if I'm being honest with you.
...such as price controls, increasing salaries, and negotiating debt with foreign lenders.
La inflación es un fenómeno histórico en la Argentina.
Motherfuckers is greedy, bro. Because motherfuckers is greedy. That's all this shit is about.
Peso plummeting, people are rushing to buy dollars. But the government limits who can make exchanges and how much they can get, creating a vast illegal market.
What? Exchange dollar. What?
Downtown Buenos Aires is packed with arbolitos, money exchangers selling dollars for about twice the official rate.
That's... Excuse me. That's crazy.
And some savvy arbolitos, like Fernando Santangelo, will deliver them right to your door. On a good day, he's exchanging up to $20,000 for clients all across Buenos Aires.
Ah, that's ridiculous. Amigo?
Tranquilo, ¿viste? ¿Cuánto me pediste? Cinco, ¿no?
Cinco son para él y dos para...
Wow.
Pero la gente necesita comprar dólares y de alguna forma tiene que buscarlo. Esta es la única opción, recurrir al mercado negro.
That's fucking crazy.
WhatsApp, it's through, you know, posting on Facebook. Tell us a little bit about how that works.
Me pongo en las redes, en Facebook, más que todo en Facebook.
Facebook.
A buscar
Facebook. Clientes.
Por ejemplo, mira, tengo un cliente que me acaba de escribir que necesita pesos para $1,000.
Nah, that's crazy. 100% inflation is fucking ridiculous. Let's be honest. That's fucking insane, bro. All right, we got about 13 minutes left before I gotta dip out. So let's watch one more video. And I'm gonna leave, and then I will be back tomorrow around the same time, probably around like 2-3 o'clock ish. It will be on some gamer shit. Let me find it. What's a cool vid we can watch? What's something that's on right now? Right now, I had a pee low key though. ASAP Rocky came out with a new video. Should we watch music videos? I kind of want to do that tomorrow. Yeah, we'll watch music videos tomorrow. Oh god, I gotta pee. Oh fuck. Give me a second. Because I can't hold it. Yo. Yo. Y'all hear me? Y'all hear me?
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Hey, man. We all go through the same shit, man. Alright? It's the last video. Yeah, let's get into it.
I didn't know that shit.
Yeah, the camera's been on, man. We've been on, man.
Well, you know I gotta at least give my man a few minutes. I gotta, J-O-N, it ain't a show without this nigga.
All right. He about to come out. Okay, I mean, he seem like he got an entrance. He about to come out. I need him to come in.
Hey. Hey.
You gonna have your own band playing behind you. You gonna be a nigga with a hand drum come out. There it is.
Talk to me nice or don't talk to me at all. Bitch, yes, I'm sir. Really here, yeah, I'm really yes, here to ball. I don't give a fuck, summertime or the fall. I'ma make it sure it's hot for them all. Yeah, it's hell time. Yeah, you know, No, niggas got locked up. Yeah, they doing fed time. But it's still cool. Now you niggas know you're riding niggas meal, dude. What I will do. Big shit popping now. That was a hook, DC.
Them niggas ain't got shit going right over that motherfucker.
What's that strip club down this way?
That's the one. I'll shoot up the diamonds right quick and I'll be back.
Damn.
In due time.
We almost
in
there.
What'd you want? Shut up, you talking about that.
Bro, why can't I get my hair long like DC, bro?
Like I ain't important no more.
I've grown my hair for 4 years. This shit ain't gone nowhere. Yeah. What am I doing wrong?
A whole bunch of shit.
Hell. I need someone to twist my hair, bro.
I think we had too much fun.
I just don't trust people.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, lit. Because people was just not showing who they really were. You like, I can't believe it. What these motherfuckers.
Now you know.
Now you know what's going on. Now motherfuckers don't want to show you how they really are. They trying to switch it around.
Goddamn, yeah. Well, that's how you wake up in the room.
Well,
now we got two speakers.
From both of
now
feet?
We got two speakers.
That shit was loud, like it came from the sky. Man, I almost blew my high. Everybody jumped, they were like, I was like, pass my pistol.
We doing the show by
pack the pistol.
Today, my boy.
No cap.
I don't know what's the initials.
Shit. We went from the trap to the backyard.
Uh-huh.
Hey.
But it's temporary, though.
Sandlot right there.
Yeah, it's temporary.
It's going to be a big old dog.
Because you know we done moved into the new studio, bro. We over here 85.
I could tell.
Make it ready.
The show said that and I was like, hold up, wait. Our fence ain't straight.
Let's do another day.
But we couldn't, so we had to come this way.
Hey, it's temporary, man. We
coming still up. Beautiful because it's ours, man.
Yeah.
You're
it's on us. It's
fuck you talking about?
Work.
Still right. In the trap, nigga.
You know what I mean? Yeah. You just upgraded, man.
Fuck is you talking about? Fuck is you talking about?
To come and be in charge and run shit the way we want to run it, man.
Straight that's like that.
It's like when you get a new spot and you got to sleep on the air mattress for 2 nights till your bed comes.
Right.
Yes, sir.
2 months.
Yes, sir. Hey, y'all know. Hey, listen.
You like this shit lit.
Y'all don't know about the air mattress, nigga. You wake up on the air. You sleep on the air mattress. You know what I'm saying? You wake. You sleep and you floating. You wake up, nigga. You on the ground, nigga. Air mattress lifestyle. You know what I'm saying? Y'all don't know nothing about that right there.
No cap.
Hey. No cap. Hey. No cap.
Hey, who?
Hey.
Landlord.
No cap.
No cap.
I really want to say, man, cut some of these goddamn lights off.
Type shit. Cause you paying for that, bitch. Cause you paying for that, bitch. Your niggas paying for that shit. Y'all paying for that shit.
I'm telling you. Y'all acting like y'all can't see it. Cause these motherfuckers die, how? So
I don't.
In the front
time,
how?
I don't.
They don't go off.
The callers are serious. Turn off them goddamn lights.
You can't do it on his phone.
Ryan
got it on his phone. You ain't got the shit on your phone?
You can cut these off.
You can cut them motherfuckers off. Not these permanent? I told
y'all. What you mean? Y'all think I know how to cut them off?
Hell no.
Not in here. They'd have been on the motion sensors. So.
All right, well, sit y'all ass down. Stop acting like you're doing something important. Everybody stood up like that's going to make it happen.
Don't take it. Ain't going nowhere. What's the other side of the room?
Yeah. It don't matter. We ain't here today, though, DC, and we get ready to keep this show real black.
Hey!
Black like a haircut on the front porch.
Talk to me. Talk to me.
Black like when your sister got her ear burnt because your mom was pressing her hair for Easter Sunday.
Or she did it on purpose.
Right. I'm talking about black like
that too. That too.
Y'all yard. That don't run no more, but they got all the baby clothes.
I never had a yard. Never in my life.
I'm talking about black like your dog black, and he don't eat dog food. He just eat the shit that y'all didn't make it to.
Leftover Thanksgiving.
You know your mama a good lady, but she got almost one too many baby daddies black. Like, if she had one more, then you a judge.
Right.
Right.
Like, everybody got, like, two kids a piece. Every daddy got two kids a piece.
Right. And then it's like them for real.
No cap. No cap.
Right.
I feel what you're saying.
I'm talking about everybody who grew up in the hood and your grandma was loose. Everybody grandma in the hood got one baby daddy that they don't want to talk about. It's always your uncle daddy. And he always got his own daddy. Ain't that
your uncle daddy? Who the fuck is my uncle daddy? Ain't my uncle daddy my grandpa? My uncle's daddy. My uncle daddy's my grandpa. Talking about my grandpa? I don't know.
How he do that? Out of 12 kids.
He got his own daddy.
He got his own daddy. That crazy.
12?
I'm talking about, we about to keep it so black.
So today. Black.
So black.
We got a very special guest in the house with us today.
Talk to me. Talk to me. Who we got? Who we got?
I start with, first of all, he's an activist.
Word.
He's an author.
Producer.
Producer, filmmaker.
Are you talking about me?
Writer.
Yes, okay, yes. Okay.
Motherfucker make some cold ass music. One of the brothers that they were like, when he speak, people listen because we believe what he's saying and we know that he know what the fuck he talking about. Right.
They talking about me.
He gave us hit after hit, volume after volume of Hidden Colors, then put us up on so much information.
Let me scoot back. Let me scoot back.
Come on. As a black community.
Talk your talk. Mm-hmm.
I feel like he's very important to the culture and where we going. And gotten the conscience of all of that. We've been trying to put this shit together for a minute, and we finally made it happen on our move-in day.
Hey.
Other day,
hey.
Tariq Nasheed. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Look at
this,
brother, man. That was a good one.
I was playing. I was playing.
First of all,
with y'all brothers for the longest, man.
Much respect to you.
I was talking about
much love to
I was talking about me.
You're speaking life into the community, man. How did all this start?
Man, I started doing the Hidden Colors series, but let's go back.
I remember, I got that. I got that. Wait. Talk to me. Yeah, he didn't cross his foot.
Yes.
The Mac Within. I read this book when I was in middle school, man, and this is still one of the best
Mac
books
Within.
That I've ever read because it teaches you how to empower yourself as a man and the things that you need to know as a man, not just from what you need to do in regards to your interactions with women, but what you need to do in regards to your interactions within yourself.
And then sometimes bring that book up, like when you go on big platforms to try to discredit the shit that you're saying, and be like, oh, he wrote a book about being a pimp.
No, it's not about being a pimp.
You feel me? But the title with the white people, and they always try to make it seem like he was pimping and pandering and all that type of bullshit.
Right, and the book was nothing like that.
Right.
We had the Mac Within, and before the Mac Within,
it's a big ass watch.
The Art of Mackin'. I wrote the book in 99, came out in 2000, huge best-selling book.
Right.
Sold 250,000 copies. That,
accomplishment, my brother. That's accomplishment, my brother.
That book at the time, you had a bunch of books out, like Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus, all of these relationship books that was telling men corny shit that really didn't work. So at the time, I said, I'm going to tell dudes real relationship advice from a real guy's perspective, unapologetically. So I said, I'm going to have a book called The Art of Mackin', talking about how to holler, how to get your shit together, how to carry yourself as a man from a lot of the street perspectives.
Right, right, right.
And people respected where I was coming from. Women got that book more than men at one point. Women wanted to see where, how we really thought as men.
Right.
When dudes write books for women, they know dudes are kind of putting on a facade.
For sure.
They know they're pandering. And women like a nigga who's pandering.
Facts.
I've seen some of you guys, your live shows, when you guys are keeping the 100, the women fans are into it more than the dudes.
Right.
That's
women
a fact.
Respect the dude who's going to be brutally honest with them.
Yep.
And that's what I was doing with my books. It took off, and I created a whole lane, man. The whole
honesty is the key, bro.
Started because of
stop
that.
Bullshit. Honesty is the key.
I morphed into talking about relationships as it relates
I'm
to
tweet
race.
That.
Right.
Because all of that ties into
same
thing too.
I'm lying.
Around 2010, I started producing a film called Hidden Colors,
right? Mm-hmm.
And I started doing that because at the time, a lot of the movies that were out were like The Blind Side, The Help, The Butler, stuff like that, and movies that were disempowering.
White savior movies.
Yeah, mm-hmm. We would come out. I remember seeing Precious and seeing the black people coming out of the movie theater just deflated.
Yeah.
Just killed.
I never saw
our
that
spirit.
Movie.
And movies like that would kill our spirit. So I said, we need to counter that stuff. We need to have something that balances all of this negativity out. So I said, I'm going to put together a movie that's so damn black, and unapologetic, and going in on white supremacy. Because a lot of people are afraid to do that. When we talk about racism, we make this shit real vague. Well, racism is out there, but there's some discrimination, there's some hatred, there's some bigotry. Now, let's put a name on it. Mm-hmm. There's a certain group within the dominant society who practice something called white supremacy racism. Let's call that out, and then let's take it from there. So I did the Hidden Colors series. Well, I did the first Hidden Colors, 2011. No movie had been done like that before, where you're just talking about all of this untold black history. I didn't know how people were going to receive the movie. We had a screening in Los Angeles, and we had a screening in some other cities. And I'm in the theater with a hat on, like, if people don't like this shit, I'm going to sneak up out of here.
Right.
You know. And after the movie was done, people just sat there in shock. It was like people had to be debriefed because they've never seen all of that information about themselves that was so powerful. And the series just took off from there. We have 5 volumes. We did Hidden Colors 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Then I did a movie called 1804 about the history of Haiti.
Yeah.
My last film was a film called Buck Breaking that talked about the sexual exploitation that has been done to black people and the sexual agendas. So that one was a huge seller. So, you know, that's I just found my lane with the movie game, man.
Well, you know what was real impressive about the movies, though, is like some of the like the information that you have in there, like you can tell that it's well researched. Like you had the clip of George Washington Carver's actual speaking voice.
Yeah, a lot of folks never heard him speak.
Exactly. Yeah. Like it'd be shit like
that's
that.
Crazy.
You up, like the pictures of Sarah Bartman.
Yeah.
Outside of you know the one that's famous. So it's like you go deep into this shit and it'd be fucking me up. Just to sit there and watch this.
That's why it's hidden. There's a lot of information that they'll just tell you half of it. They don't tell you the other half. George Washington Carver, speaking to him, this brother, his voice was very high-pitched.
Right.
And a lot of folks didn't know that. His voice was high-pitched because they castrated him when he was a kid because he was adopted by a white family. They didn't want him having sex with their daughter.
Right.
You see?
Wow.
There's so much hidden history. Everywhere you go, it's hidden. We're in Atlanta right now. You go into the heart of Atlanta, there's a statue of Henry Grady. And you hear people in Atlanta say that they're Grady babies.
Mm-hmm.
It's Grady Hospital, Grady School. Henry Grady was known for being a white supremacist. His job was to come down to the South and to codify the South and the North after the Civil War, saying, hey, look, we're all white. We have to maintain white supremacy and keep these Negroes down. That is our job. And that's the only thing he's known for. A lot of
that's
folks don't
crazy.
Know that. He's not a politician. He wasn't a bank owner.
And
he
wasn't a statue of this thing.
He was just known as the white supremacist of his day. And there's a big-ass statue in the middle of Atlanta of Henry Grady, you see? There's hidden history all over the place. I was just in Kennesaw the other day. I have a museum. We just bought a museum in Los Angeles called the Hidden History Museum.
Thank you.
People don't understand, outside of Atlanta, it's a whole different damn world.
Right.
The rest of Georgia is not like Atlanta. So we went 30 minutes outside of Atlanta. We went to Kennesaw. We were looking for some artifacts for our museum. There's a Klan store right in Kennesaw. They frame it as a Civil War store, but inside the store they have Klan memorabilia, they have nigger dolls, literally with the word nigger dolls for sale in this thing, right in Kennesaw. And they've been trying to get rid of this store and get it up out of there. But this just showed, yeah, it's been on the news. So this just shows how deeply ingrained anti-black racism is and how close it is to us, and we don't really see it like we should.
And it's surprisingly a lot of places like that. I did a thing up in Tennessee,
yeah.
And it's this guy calls himself the father of the Confederacy, and he has a store where he has all types of racist memorabilia and all types of, I mean, pictures of black people that you can come buy and
it's targets like and shit.
All types of stuff that's just available and open. And
the Klan was started in Tennessee.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, Nathan Bedford Forrest.
Nathan Bedford Forrest.
Yeah. Damn. They started the Klan out there in Tennessee. So they're real big on that memorabilia and that imagery. And they sell a lot of this stuff on the
internet. Whoever's watching, I appreciate you for watching. Thank you.
Getting lynched and hung, and they actually still
sell. I love you, and I'm about to bust.
Because remember, when black people were getting lynched, they would sever the body parts and sell them on the underground. Mm-hmm. When Nat Turner got killed, they would sell his
body. We're on some serious shit right now, I ain't gonna lie.
His body and sold the oil. The family of Nat Turner just got his skull back a few years ago because they were selling his skull on the underground. So damn. These people, they do some real sick stuff out here, man.
Jesus fuck. Jesus fuck, bruh. I ain't gonna lie, I'm about to get off in a minute, so. I just wanna hear about this.
I see you! DJ Kunta!
DJ Kunta is crazy.
Movies, you, in my opinion, are responsible for introducing to the world to a lot of the
if you're watching me, listen. Yeah. If you're watching me, please follow. I'm going to do it 24 hours if I get 10 followers. If you're following me, if you're watching me, follow me, please. All right? I'm on this bitch every single week for the past 6 months. All right? Follow me. I'm going to do it 24 hours. We're going to have some good times, some bad times. You know what I'm saying? I fuck with you. I love you. Follow me, please. Yo.
That you know, the people that we look to as, you know, influencers in the woke community and all of that. Mm-hmm. Like, how was your vetting process in finding these people? Did you have one, or did you just let them come to you?
I looked out for them. When I first started doing Hidden Colors, the way I was going to do it at first, it was just going to be me on film talking about history, and the film was going to be called Secret Niggas. So I said, oh, that might be a little too rough.
It's a little rough.
Mixtape.
Yeah. Secret Niggas. Secret Niggas is a little rough. Okay.
Take it over the underground, bro.
You did.
Harriet, I see you. DJ Kunta.
Okay.
So I said, I want this to play in school. So let me be, you know.
At some point, I wanted to be a history teacher. I ain't going to cut.
Profanity in them. Hidden Colors 5, we do a little cursing in there, but most of them is very clean because I want them in schools. So I said, let me change the name. Let me call it Hidden Colors, and let me get a lot of scholars that I study, that I like. A lot of these scholars were popular on the underground scene, but they just kind of almost retired to a certain degree. So I started getting some of the people that I loved and respected, like Dr. Frances Cress Welsing, who's a genius and who's very underrated, and we're doing a lot of things paying homage to her in our museum because she wrote a book called...
It's almost Black History Month. Really, I better get ready. I'm about to be real black on this bitch. I'm going to be real black on this motherfucker.
The keys to the color. She was a brilliant psychiatrist up in D.C., my brother Chico's hometown.
Yes, sir. Mm-hmm.
And this sister DC. Was very controversial because she broke racism down and made it simple by saying white supremacy and systematic racism is about genetic survival of the dominant society. Mm-hmm. The root of them practicing racism is for their survival, because interacting and mixing with black people, the offspring is going to be black. Mm-hmm. So in order to thwart that, you have to control black sexuality. That's why when black people were lynched, they were castrated.
Okay.
That's why they had miscegenation laws that prevented black people from marrying those in the dominant society. So she broke that down, and that woke up a lot of people. Then I started getting other scholars like Dr. Kaba, Brother James Small, Brother Phil Valentine. Nas was in one of my things. I had so many phenomenal people in the Hidden Colors series, and it just took off from there.
So what started your journey? What made you want to go?
Oh, my gosh. All right, we're 20 minutes into this. Listen. I will be back tomorrow. I am not going nowhere. I know I say I will always be back tomorrow, but I actually am going to be back tomorrow. I'm off tomorrow. I don't have a single motherfucking thing to do tomorrow. We might work out. We might cook some. We might, you know what I'm saying? But just know I'm here tomorrow, probably around 2 or 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And Yeah. Right now I'm getting off. We did a cool, you know what I'm saying, almost a cool 4 hours. Cool little almost 4 hours. But it's been a fantastic stream. I love y'all, and
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
There's that too. You know what I'm saying? So I love y'all with the utmost respect and loveliness. And enjoy the rest of your Sunday. Enjoy the rest of your day. Alright, I love y'all. Here.
Lord have mercy, I'm about to bust.
Y'all know I love y'all. I know I fuck with y'all. Stay in tune. I'll be back tomorrow.
Over there. It's a task manager. It's a project manager. It's a